smothering defense. No matter who starts, lifted Boston. Do the Heat have an answer? Let's find out in Game 3. American Airlines Arena welcoming back Dwayne Wade and the Heat as he gets set for Game 3 of this opening round best of seven series against Kevin Garnett, who sat out Game 2. Didn't make any difference as far as the Celtics were concerned. As we look at the Eastern Conference playoffs, the road team has still failed to win a game. Chicago winning at home to beat Cleveland. The other three teams up 2-0, holding serve on their home floor. Good evening, everyone. Along with Mark Jackson and Jeff Van Gundy, Mike Breen on hand. Lisa Salter's with us as well as the Boston Celtics come in with that 2-0 lead. Now, granted, they just held serve at home, but they demoralized Miami in that Game 2. One of the worst playoff losses in franchise history, Mark. The body language wasn't there. They seemed to be fighting with each other a little bit. How did they get back in the series?
Well, you get back by giving help to Dwayne Wade. Got to find a way for other guys to play with confidence and aggressiveness. You talk about during the regular season, Wade was spectacular, and he got help from other guys. Once the postseason started, and you talk about playoff basketball, a disappearing act. I say they got to put on the shoes of Dorothy. Have a mentality like there's no place like home. They got to regain their swagger and confidence in this building.
Oh, this is going to be a special night. We have a Wizard of Oz reference at the top of the telecast. Meanwhile, the Boston Celtics, it was like the defense of old, dominating the first two games. If they play defense like that, this could be a very short series.
Well, all they have to guard against is what a lot of teams do when they go up 2-0. Subconsciously let up, let down, and give life to the Miami Heat. If they are in lockdown mode, they can still guard as good as any team in the NBA, and Boston's going to have to do it tonight, particularly against the assault of Dwayne Wade.
Eric Spoelstra, the head coach of the Miami Heat, says their number one strength all year, they've been resilient. They've bounced back every time. They need to bounce back tonight for Game 3 coming up.
Well, the Miami Heat trying to get back into the series. Mark Jones back in the studio along with Jalen Rose and the coach Avery Johnson. Three pivotal Game 3s coming up on the ESPN family of networks tonight, set up by a couple of critical Game 2s a couple of nights ago. And one of the great stories in these playoffs so far has been the Utah Jazz and Jerry Sloan doing a great job coaching this undermanned group. Deron Williams leading the way with 33 points and 14 rebounds as they even up their series against the Denver Nuggets a couple of nights ago. Meanwhile, the San Antonio Spurs pulling a bit of a surprise, led by Tim Duncan. San Antonio relying on their veteran leader and Manu Ginobili back to his old self. They even their series against the Dallas Mavericks as Richard Jefferson took to heart some of the detrimental comments that his head coach talked about, as he said some of them frankly played like dogs while they were the big dogs in Game 2. Jalen, when you talk about San Antonio Dallas series, what kind of adjustments do you anticipate against Manu Ginobili, who was so key in their win?
You have to find a way to control Manu Ginobili if you have an opportunity to beat the Spurs, because he's a playmaker on the offensive end. He does it off the dribble. He shoots threes. You must find a way to force him to guard Caron Butler defensively, even if that means getting Sean Marion out of the starting lineup to force that matchup. Here you see Manu Ginobili getting ready for the pick and roll. As a lefty, you're forced to go right your entire life. So guess what? Jason Kidd goes under the screen. Manu's used to going right. Bang, he knocks three in this series. So you have to make Manu work on both ends of the floor, coach. He's the starter, and he's the closer.
You guys both know something about going left. I'm sitting beside two of them right here in the studio. A righty, though, Deron Williams, 33 points, 14 assists. How did they slow him down, Denver?
Yes, Deron Williams is basically destroying the Denver Nuggets. He's averaging 29 points and 12 assists in this series in 42 minutes. He's really confident and comfortable right now, especially in pick-and-roll situations. And in pick-and-roll situations, the Denver Nuggets are making a critical error. Here you see Deron Williams, only his man that's on the ball, J.R. Smith's trying to guard the basketball. So that's what they call a drop in zone. What they need to do is trap in zone. Commit maybe two guys to Deron Williams, allow the other three guys to zone up, force him to pass, and make some other guys score and make some plays.
Is it the system or Deron Williams there in Utah that's so successful?
Oh, man, it's Deron Williams. But, you know, Deron Williams, John Stockton, hey, they've had a great run with Jerry Sloan in that system for years.
But they have so many injuries. AK is out of the lineup as well as Okoro. You have to find a way to make somebody else beat you.
Jerry Sloan, as I mentioned, doing a great coaching job. Meanwhile, Eric Spoelstra under the spotlight tonight down on Biscayne Boulevard and 8th Street in Miami, Florida. A look at the captain meeting at American Airlines Arena. Dwayne Wade looking for a helping hand on offense. And Kevin Garnett, he watched the last game from his GM's basement. Back after this.
ESPN's presentation of the NBA playoffs. Brought to you by Ford and Lincoln Mercury Service. Expertise, convenience, and value. And Amway Global, where positivity powers our people, products, and businesses.
The amount of technology in today's cars is like something out of a spaceship, which is why mechanics nowadays are more like rocket scientists. They have to be. The technicians in Ford and Lincoln Mercury dealerships are highly trained. They really do know their stuff. And they have all the parts to make sure the job gets done right.
Get the works, an oil change, tire rotation, and more. Just $29.95 or less after $10 mail-in rebate.
Is this thing to email?
You betcha.
See? Smart and friendly.
At Amway Global, our positive outlook comes naturally. We harvest healthy plant ingredients from our own organic farms, ingredients found in our Nutrilite supplements, and offer more than 450 quality products, from Planet Posit cleaners to botanically infused skincare. Positivity, powering the products, the people, and the businesses of Amway Global. To learn more, contact an Amway Global independent business owner.
Ever wonder how amazing it would be to experience life in another dimension? We did. Introducing Samsung 3D TV, the world's first 3D LED TV. That's the wonder of Samsung.
Power guys, they battled back.
Behind Kevin Durant, the Thunder storm back to take game three. Now the Lakers look to regroup in a pivotal game four. The NBA playoffs, Hawks, Bucks, and Lakers Thunder, tomorrow on ESPN.
A gorgeous day in Miami this afternoon as the Heat and the Celtics have traveled south after games one and two in Boston. Dwayne Wade of the Heat badly outplayed, especially in game two, but they're ready to be back on their home floor and try and get into the win column in this opening round best of seven playoff series. And for the first time tonight, let's welcome in Lisa Salters. Hey, Lisa.
Hey, Mike. Well, Heat head coach Eric guys, this is not the time to panic, but he says this is the time to get into the fight. He told us that our guys have to recognize that this is a fight, and the way we play our game isn't just good enough to compete, but it's good enough to win. Dwayne Wade told me that we can't just come out tonight in game three and meet Boston's energy level. We have to exceed it. He said they have guys over there who were the champions in 2008, so they understand the moment. Said we have guys on our side, some guys who are still trying to figure out the moment. Well, Mike, if the Heat don't figure it out tonight, this series, as you said earlier, could be over quickly.
No question, Lisa, as we look at our starting lineups presented by Popeyes as we get set for game three. And first for the visitors, and they had a better road record than home record this year. Kevin Garnett back in the starting lineup. Glenn Davis served well in the one-game suspension for Garnett. Davis had 23, but the regular starting five in place for Doc Rivers. And for the Miami Heat, so much made about they need some scoring up front with Jermaine O'Neal and Michael Beasley. They also need better point guard play Carlos Arroyo, who's the starter, and Mario Chalmers have been outplayed by the backcourt of the Boston Celtics. As we're set to go, and it's hard to say which Heat team's going to show up. You can say that for the Celtics. Guys, both these teams during the regular season, you just never knew which team was going to show up. They were both inconsistent, despite the fact that Boston won 50 and Miami 47. So it's really hard to gauge where you're going to see. Jeff, are you surprised on how badly the Heat were outplayed in game two?
Well, I wasn't surprised because the impact of Kevin Garnett's suspension always will energize a team. And Glenn Davis came out and played great basketball, as did the whole Celtic team. I was surprised, though, at how dominant the win was.
And Boston, Mark, they played so well, especially defensively. But we've seen them every time you say, oh, they're ready to turn the corner and be that dominant, consistent team, something else happens. So we don't know really what we're going to see from the Celtics as well.
And that's why it'll be very interesting. Understanding this is a veteran basketball team. They're up 2-0. It's an opportunity to absolutely take the will of the Miami Heat. Do the Celtics respond by going after it, or do they give life to this Heat basketball team?
Miami at home this year, 24-17. They were not a great home team. As the Celtics 26-15 on the road during the regular season. As we said, a better road record than home record. And Garnett is back. And that man needs to pick it up for Miami. He has really struggled in the first couple of games. The former All-Star Jermaine O'Neal, who has so much playoff experience, they need him to be aggressive.
We need to find a new word for struggle. Because when you're 4-for-24, that's a beyond a struggle. I don't know what it is. It's a drought, it's something, but you got to come up in your vocabulary with a word that is appropriate for 4-for-24.
He's been brutal the first two games. Is that better?
That's getting better. You're getting warm.
And I think easier for him to get out of this rut that he's in. Do it by offensive rebounding, putting himself in position to score underneath.
Crowd continues to file in. Late arriving crowd here is Quentin Richardson's first shot of the night won't go. Richardson, who is not suspended for game two, but fined $25,000 for his role in their altercation. Garnett kicks it out. Pierce takes a three, sets himself. That won't go way off, only on the rebound. Miami has scored just 76 and 77 points in the first two games. I'd like to say they're struggling, but I'm afraid. Richardson to O'Neal, and his elbow jump shot won't go. He's now 4-of-25.
But I don't think, you know, the Heat got 47 wins in the year, which to me is miraculous, because they just don't have a lot of offensive weapons. Besides Dwayne Wade, if Beasley's not going well, they don't have one other guy that can create his own shot.
Rondo to Garnett. And Garnett gets the first points of the night. Miami, during the regular season, were 25th in the league in scoring, so they're certainly not an offensive juggernaut. They were an excellent defensive team. That's one of the reasons why they got to that fifth spot in the Eastern Conference playoff seeding.
But being back home, I fully expect other guys to make shots tonight.
Wade, tough shot falling away. All right, how about Wade's balance between wanting to take over and get a win, but at the same time making sure that they get balanced scoring?
I'm a guy to believe that you can do both. You can take over on the offensive end and allow the defense to tell you whether it's you scoring or you facilitating. You've got to read the defense and make the proper decision.
I couldn't agree more, because to come into a game saying you're going to either pass or you're going to shoot, you've got to do what the defense dictates. If he's left single coverage, go to score. The second man comes, trust your teammate.
That foul on Richardson is first. Pierce getting booed. Garnett, of course, will get booed as he touches the ball. Pierce able to convert.
You don't play better defense than Quentin Richardson just played. That's outstanding defense, just better offense by Pierce.
So public enemies number one and two at the first couple of buckets for Boston. There's Arroyo. Ray Allen starts on Wade. The ball deflected by Allen. 9 on the shot clock. Saw the numbers. Wade shooting 61% from the field in the first two games. His teammates 32%. Perkins picks him up on a switch. Richardson off the dribble. 1-for-4 start for Miami.
The fans want Garnett to touch it. They can get him. Their booze going. Rivers launches one. Ball batted away by Perkins. And here comes Arroyo. Arroyo misses on the follow from Dwayne Wade. That gets the crowd fired up as well. In both games, the Heat started off fairly well. In fact, they had a 13-point lead in the third quarter of game one. Had a 4-point lead early in the second of game two, and then the roof collapsed both times. Ray Allen, quick catch and shoot. That one in and out. Perkins, the offensive board, gathers himself, blocked by O'Neal. Perkins said it was more than a block. It's going to be Celtic ball.
And you want to give yourself a chance early on in the ball game. Well, play with passion and force. A great job of attacking the offensive board. Dwayne Wade climbs the back. A rim. Big time finish.
And a foul away from the ball. It's going to go against Michael Beasley. So Beasley picks up his first. Beasley's been the big topic in the papers and on the talk shows here in Miami, hoping that he starts to get aggressive. He's such an offensive talent, but has been very erratic in his two seasons here. Rondo to Perkins. Nice touch pass to Garnett, who comes up short. Garnett nearly keeps it alive, but Arroyo, good hustle. Richardson trying to post up. Stripped by Rondo. Knocked away by Wade. And O'Neal for the open jumper. Well, Dwayne Wade has both buckets in that hustle play, giving their third.
I really like the energy of the Heat early on in this ballgame. Defensively chasing down loose rebounds, loose basketball. That's how you create offense.
Garnett comes up short. Beasley was saying, Garnett in the first game, first couple of games. Obviously, Garnett didn't play in the second one, but after the first one, he said, he got me. Garnett likes to get into the minds of young players as Beasley misses that. O'Neal with a foul, can't get it to go. And Garnett the rebound. Ray Allen, that's the spot he was red hot from in the third quarter of game two when he had 17 in the period.
And that was caused because Dwayne Wade is attacking the offensive board. Didn't get that one and thus couldn't get back and get to Ray Allen for the spot up in transition.
Good contesting all. Nice outlet pass and Rondo to finish. Perkins started it all by contesting the shot and then the Celtics get an easy bucket.
And if you want to win, you don't give up transition baskets. And the Heat, two times in a row, 5 points have been given up already in transition.
Eric Spoelstra asking his team as Beasley throws it away. Allen went out of bounds, came back in. The Garnett inside misses. Allen's tip won't go. And a foul's going to go against Quentin Richardson. That's going to be his second.
Well, again, Wade attacked the offensive board, so Arroyo had to play two. There's no one better and no one more dangerous than Ray Allen shooting the transition three.
And that's a good read by Rondo in transition, waiting until Ray Allen got into position to catch and shoot.
Miss from the free throw.
Too early. Put him in position where the defense is falling back in the paint and then run into the body. So he's in position where all he's got to do is catch the basketball and do exactly what he does best, shoot.
And you know the rule, right?
Tell
you
him.
Know it.
Tell him.
Hand down, hand down.
Allen, 0 for 4 in game one from three-point range, 7 of 9 in game two as the Celtics have now reeled off 6 straight.
And Mike, I don't care what the numbers say about him not shooting the three as well this year. When that guy is open and he raises up, I don't think he's ever missing.
And he doesn't think he's ever missing as Wade bangs it in. Wade hasn't missed yet. He's 3 for 3. Rondo, nice penetration. That scoop layup can't finish. Perkins' tip won't go.
That's why I believe that Dwayne Wade has got to be physically worn out at the end of this basketball game. He's got to keep the ball in his hands and make plays.
Oh, beautiful move from Wade. Slice
thing through the defense. He's got 8 of their 10 points.
In order for the Heat to win this game, it's got to be Dwayne Wade making play.
Darrell Wright has come into the game for Jason Pierce. And Beasley picks up his second foul. So some decisions for Eric Spoelstra as his two front court forwards, each with two personals.
Early on, it's the Dwayne Wade show. Lulling to sleep and then getting into the paint area, able to finish. Stellar job, crossover, shooting 4 for 4 from the field, knocking down shots. The rest of the team 1 for 8, but Dwayne Wade, keep him alive.
Where'd you get that sandwich?
Hey, pal.
I said, where'd you get that sandwich?
Oh, I heard you. Only problem is, this ain't a sandwich. It's a tortada.
Hey, pal, would you get that tortada?
Don't call it a sandwich. Taco Bell's new premium chicken tortada. Fire-grilled all-white meat chicken in your choice of 2 bold flavors. It's a whole lot tastier than a sandwich.
I never, as a woman, thought I'd get a heart attack. It's just out of the blue at 43. Now I'm on an aspirin regimen because it helps me live the life I want
to
live.
Be sure to talk to your doctor before you begin an aspirin regimen.
It's not a big deal to go to your doctor. It is a big deal to have a heart attack.
Rated R, starts April 30th.
Being able to meet when you want allows you to do a lot more with your day.
I go running with the dogs, and then I do most of my meetings in my running clothes.
You can just be working on it at the same time, and you don't have to be in the same place.
It allows you as a business to be more flexible. It just allows you to do more with less.
Put meetings in their place with GoToMeeting. With one click, GoToMeeting lets you hold online meetings from anywhere. Everyone in your meeting can give presentations and sales demos, edit documents, and collaborate in real time, whether on a PC or a Mac. Hold unlimited online meetings with integrated phone and VoIP conferencing for just $49 a month.
I started GoToMeeting, and now everybody's looking at the same document.
We're able to have the kind of informal dialogue with the clients that is like being there.
I use GoToMeeting to reinvent how we do business.
GoToMeeting lets you do things that otherwise you just wouldn't do.
We just couldn't function without it.
Try GoToMeeting free today. Visit GoToMeeting.com and use the promo code SPORTS.
Heat and Celtics tied at 10, like it was in the first two games. So far, it's been all Dwayne Wade. The rest of the team struggling. And Wade's saying he can't do it alone and wants his team to know that.
Overall, what did that do to my teammates? What did it do to their mind state? Do they feel that I've lost trust in them? Faith in him. I got to think about all this. So I continue to believe in him, you know, and understand that we're not at this point without each other. And, you know, we came in this thing together and we're going to go out together, you know. So I'm always believing these guys, knowing that it takes a whole team to win. And, you know, one guy can really turn it up and can will you to one win, but one guy can't will you to 4.
And this in the first couple of games in the series, as you see the numbers much lower than the regular season for most of the supporting cast. And down the stretch of the regular season, when the Heat went 12-1 in the final 13 games, and granted the level of competition wasn't the highest, but they had good ball movement and very good balance. Everybody seemed to get involved.
Yeah, but that wasn't against playoff caliber teams, and what playoff caliber teams do is defend. And so it is going to be on Wade. The only thing I'm going to disagree with Wade on is I saw him actually win a series by himself against the Mavericks. 34.7 points a game. It was the best 4 games I've seen anyone put together in a row, and that was won completely on his greatness.
Well, that was when they were down 2-0 in the 2006 finals and were down big in game 3 before Wade put on, as you said, one of the all-time great performances in NBA history. 2 on the shot clock, right to Haslam, who just checked in, and Haslam knocks it down.
That's why I like this lineup that Spoelstra has on the floor right now. You know what you're going to get with Haslam, an outstanding mid-range jump shooter. Wright is a guy that can score points, so it creates more weapons on the floor for Wade.
And Haslam's a fierce competitor. You don't have to wonder what you're going to get with him.
At both ends of the floor, Perkins trying to bully his way in and took the travel. Good defense from Haslam.
And you talk about Haslam, reminds me so much of a guy that you coached and I played alongside of, Charles Oakley. His presence on the floor, extremely high IQ, can knock down the mid-range jump shot, and a big-time competitor.
Absolutely. And you, at that position, you have to have someone who's able to sacrifice his body and at the same time be a scoring threat offensively.
Darrell Wright finding Haslam. Extra pass, O'Neal, a good open look. Still can't get it to go. Wright with a good follow.
Maybe you get a little something from Darrell Wright.
And not just that putback, but he put Jermaine O'Neal in position to shoot the basketball with a wide open jump shot. His penetration putting the ball on the floor.
Wright.
Very interesting. Arroyo on Ray Allen played it totally wrong. Left Ray Allen's body and was wide open.
There he goes again. Puts it in. And a foul. Dwayne Wade. Spectacular drive to the bucket and a chance for a three-point play. He's 5 for 5 from the field.
I mean, this isn't fair. This is absolutely not fair. The ability to split the defense like this, going full steam ahead, big time finish, that's blown by 4 Celtic defenders. My goodness, what a move by Wade.
Well, you heard Lisa say that his message to his team was we have to exceed their energy. He's exceeding everybody's energy thus far. But he struggled from the free throw line so far in this series. Wade's a good free throw shooter, but he's 6 of 13 from the line. And missed that one to go forward.
How about before the game, Dwayne Wade's brother comes up to me and says, make sure you take care of my brother. It should be the other guy's family members telling me that. No, Wade is good. He's fine.
Pierce good at the other end. And Celtics back within 3. Celtics again winning the first 2. Pierce didn't have big games, but they didn't need him to have big offensive games. But they will if they want to advance near the playoffs. Right. Joel Anthony with some early minutes.
Again, the penetration of Wright. Taking pressure off of Wade to carry the offense. He's putting the ball on the floor and making plays.
And a foul away from the ball. This one's going to go against Haslam. Trying to plead his case to Bennett Salvatore.
This is just good basketball. Getting into the seams and making the right play.
Well, Eric Spoelstra said that we need to stop just being on the perimeter. We need to get a low post game coming, but not just throwing the ball in the low post to O'Neal, letting the post up, but the penetration and kick out of the open shots. It just hasn't been there on any kind of regular basis in the first 2 games. So Garnett knocks down the first.
But if you look at it, other than Wright's occasional penetration play, if it's not Wade, then who? It's not like you're going to throw the ball into Anthony or Haslam in the low post. This is, they're a limited offensive team, and that's why I think they've almost ramped up expectations. And they had a miraculous regular season, but they're not, they don't have a lot of weapons to go to. This is Dwayne Wade.
When you think they won only 3 games less than the Celtics, they won 47 games because of that quick finish as Haslam gets it to go. Haslam, a good start off the bench.
Again, they're making the right decisions off of double team and traps, finding open shooters.
Another hit, 7 of their last 8 from the field. Haslam, good defense again on Garnett. Wade for 3. Rebound tipped. Quick outlet. Ray Allen. Nice, pretty move. It goes reverse. First a crossover. Allen, so much more than a jump shooter. He's always been able to do that.
Well, you have to close to him above the 3-point line. And then when you do that, you're exposed in transition to the drive.
Mario Chalmers, good aggressive move. Joel Anthony, the offensive board. Right inside and draws the foul. So a quick entrance for Wright because of the foul trouble to Richardson, and it's paid off for Miami. And we'll have a timeout. 2.5 remaining here in the first. The Heat with a good start here in game three.
John is a Ford and Lincoln Mercury service technician. Very smart. We were just discussing the circumstances by which a person could find himself in four separate places at one time.
Well, I didn't really say that, but people come in here for tires, brakes, batteries, and oil changes.
So it's possible.
Yes.
Well, that's brilliant.
Buy with confidence, thanks to our low price tire guarantee.
So with everything you need in one convenient place, why would you go to four separate places?
Now that's a good question.
Oh, there you go.
The new BK breakfast muffin sandwich. It's not that original, but it's only a buck. Now at Burger King.
Feeling free as a bird now. Fly it, fly it. Gonna see the whole world now. Try it, try it. These days are better than before.
Geico Insurance. See how much you could save at geico.com.
Exceptional taste? That's pure Amsterdam. Amstel Light. One damn good beer.
We're always believing, no matter what we're up against.
Let's go.
You gotta dedicate yourself.
Believe.
It drives us to a great history.
We still believe that we're gonna win.
It takes some discipline.
I believe is sky high.
If you wanna be great, you gotta believe you can win.
Never stop believing, baby.
The NBA calendar as the playoffs continue. TNT on Saturday. Orlando at Charlotte for game three from Charlotte. Phoenix at Portland. Game four of that series, Suns up 2-1. Then ABC on Sunday, Boston at Miami for game four. Cleveland at Chicago, game four. Bulls got that win in game three. And then NBA TV on Monday, Atlanta at Milwaukee. Hawks winning the first two games at home in that series. Here are this one, 21-18. Heat lead the Celtics by three with 2.5 to go in the first. Let's send it over to Lisa Salters with an interested observer.
That's right, Mike. I'm with NBA Commissioner David Stern. Mr. Stern, always a pleasure for you to take your time out for us. I wanted to ask you, in recent days, you've made it very clear that you will not tolerate players or coaches criticizing officials. Why has it become such an issue recently?
Yeah, a little criticism is okay. I mean, Van Gundy refs the games all the time. So, I think that's okay. But I wanted to take some attention off of Jeff and sort of put it on the coaches and mostly the coaches. The coaches work the officials, say things, hoping that they're going to get this much of an edge. And we know that, and it's gone on for 100 years. But collectively, when they all do it, people start to believe there's something that's not right with the officiating. The officiating is pretty good. Guys work very hard. They don't get it all right. And I want the coaches to tone it down. That's all.
You said that it can be corrosive. What do you mean?
Well, if every coach is busy saying that this is terrible and that's terrible, and then when people start saying, oh, well, the referees are in cahoots, they're doing various things. They're not. We have the best officials in the world, and they're the most metricized, judge, developed, et cetera. And the coaches just do it so they can get an extra call.
The opinion that the coach is just trying to stand up for the player.
Yeah, well, he should sit down, because if every coach stands up like that, it isn't very good for the game. And it's a heck of a game. We're here in this beautiful arena in the middle of these great playoffs. I just came from Kansas City. We're here in Miami tonight, go to Charlotte tomorrow. There's a lot going on here, and the coaches should better appreciate how lucky they are to be part of the league.
I know we have another year with the current agreement, but as we move forward, a lot of folks are kind of pessimistic that a deal is going to get done. Where do you stand on that, about a collective bargaining agreement getting done?
Actually, I'm neither pessimistic nor optimistic. I'm hopeful. We're giving the players every bit of data they could possibly get. We're meeting at the staff level, and hopefully some good will come of that.
All right, thank you very much. It's always a pleasure, Commissioner. Mike?
All right, Lisa, thank you. He's on his tour now. Watch the Oklahoma City beat the Lakers last night. It was just a great, great atmosphere. Heat fans trying to bring a great atmosphere tonight so far. And the team has responded. Wade has been brilliant. Oh, spin move! And just off the rim. Wade has brought his A-plus game here in the first period. Rondo, nice hesitation block, but a goal to him.
Joel Anthony hit it after it hit the backboard.
He's made some nice moves already.
Well, you can tell it's a big-time move because we're showing a replay of a move that he didn't score.
No, but you should get a point. The referee should have the authority to say that's worth 1 point if it's a spectacular move. But no different than gymnastics where you get scored for.
Makes another move, and this time draws the foul. So who gets to the free throw line for the second time tonight?
And Mike, can we go back to what the commissioner was talking about?
Sure.
About the corrosive nature of coaches' comments or players. My feeling on that is this, as one who's had his money taken by the commissioner, is that you can look at it one of two ways. You can look at it as corrosive, as he does, or you can look at it as just part of the game. The only thing I think, if they're going to take the coaches to task like that, A, that they should be happy to be here, then we should say everybody should be happy to be here, from commissioner all the way through the players, because it is a great game. But secondly, let's hold the players and coaches accountable for their comments about each other and find them just as strictly. When Joakim Noah calls Kevin Garnett a dirty player and Cleveland is a horrible place, let's hit him too. Let's hit coaches when they denigrate either their players or other players, or players that denigrate coaches. There can't be one sacred cow, which is officials, because it can all be corrosive.
Rondo's shot won't go, and now everything is publicized, whether it's just by a regular press conference on Twitter or... Oh, nice pass, way to right. Spectacular play there. Well, Eric Bolster says we have to get into the fight. They've done it here in the first period. And Darrell Wright off the bench, 6 points in 7 minutes. They needed some help off the bench. Pierce steps back. That's a three. That goes. Pierce had his best season from three-point range during the regular season. At 41%. Final seconds. Wade for three. And that will end the first period. They've struggled so much offensively, the Miami Heat, in the first couple of games. You could say this is an explosion for them. Wade, of course, leading the way. 15 first quarter points. He did get some help, though. One quarter complete here in game three. Miami by two.
The amount of technology in today's cars is like something out of a spaceship, which is why mechanics nowadays are more like rocket scientists. They have to be. The technicians at Ford and Lincoln Mercury dealerships are highly trained. They really do know their stuff, and they have all the parts to make sure the job gets done right.
Get the works, an oil change, tire rotation, and more. Just $29.95 or less after $10 mail-in rebate.
Is this thing to email?
You betcha.
See? Smart and friendly.
Can a smartphone reach the four corners of the earth? Can it make unlimited Skype-to-Skype calls to any country without using any minutes?
Hello?
I am anyone on Skype, anywhere, giving you an all-access pass to the world. Droid can with Skype Mobile, one of thousands of apps that can run with other apps from the ever-expanding Android market. When there's no limit to what Droid gets, there's no limit to what Droid does.
One value meal coming right up. Get rid of the pickle.
What?
86 the tomato. Hey. Goodbye lettuce.
I wanted all that.
Well, sure you do. But you ordered the value meal.
At a certain point, a value meal stops being a value. Get real value and then some at Wendy's. For just $2.99, get the works piled on our Double Junior Cheeseburger Deluxe and even Applewood Smoked Bacon on our all-white meat crispy chicken deluxe. Each with fries and a drink, now just $2.99. You know when it's
real. Nobody really likes to travel that much for work.
5-hour plane travel followed by maybe a hotel room.
What things were you going to have to get done at home, you know, with your family?
Followed by getting to the actual meeting.
And there's, of course, you know, the time lost while you're gone.
Put meetings in their place with GoToMeeting. With one click, GoToMeeting lets you hold online meetings from anywhere. Everyone in your meeting can give presentations and sales demos, edit documents, and collaborate in real time, whether on a PC or a Mac. Hold unlimited online meetings with integrated phone and VoIP conferencing for just $49 a month.
You could see somebody's idea of moving something on the screen somewhere else, and yeah, that looks way better.
It's less complicated than probably most of the activities you already do on your computer.
I saved a day's worth of travel, probably $1,000 worth of expenses. With GoToMeeting, I actually made money.
It's not only the time savings, it's what's possible now.
It's one of those tools we can't live without.
Try GoToMeeting free today. Visit GoToMeeting.com and use the promo code SPORT.
Welcome back to Miami, where the Celtics are down by 2. Doc, you were telling me before the game that you did not like the defense in the first two games of this series on Dwayne Wade. 15 points in that quarter for Dwayne. What don't you like about the defense?
Well, he's catching it wherever he wants to. So, I mean, we got to make him catch it further out. That way our bigs can at least try to help. Right now, he's dominating the game, and then they're dominating the game with their energy, Lisa. They got every offensive rebound, so we have to up our energy. We have to up our physical play on Wade.
On the other end, Paul Pierce, you said he's been up and down, 9 points for him in that quarter. What's working for him?
Well, we're going to him, number one. That always helps with him, and he's got a good rhythm right now, so we just got to keep going to him and keep letting him catch the ball in space.
All right, thank you, Doc.
Thanks.
Mike?
All right, Lisa. Well, the first quarter of game one, the Heat were up by a point. After the first quarter of game two, it was tied, so they've had good first quarters. What's happened after that's a different story, especially when Wade Jeff is on the bench, which is where he is now.
Yeah, I just don't know where they're going to score. You look out there, it's going to have to either be a pick and roll for one of their perimeters or multiple pick and rolls, or go to Jermaine O'Neal and hope he can get a shot over Rasheed Wallace.
I think being at home, this team can be more effective with this unit on the line, on the floor right now. They can score because of confidence and being in their own building.
O'Neal against Rasheed Wallace. O'Neal kicks it out to Arroyo as he falls down. And a loose ball foul is going to go against Paul Pierce, and that's two on Pierce. Good aggressiveness for Wright going to the boards to draw that.
And Wright has been outstanding. Ever since he's been inserted into this ballgame, his presence has been felt, whether it be scoring, making plays, or attacking the offensive boards. He's done an outstanding job for this Heat team early on in this game.
Well, Wright, 6 points in that first quarter as Pierce sits down. He had 4 points in the first two games combined. Michael Finley comes in for the first time. O'Neal drives on Wallace. Tough runner won't go. Ball batted around into the hands of Haslam. Lost it. Rondo strips it. And the Heat will gain possession. And a backcourt violation. Arroyo left his feet in the front court, caught it in the backcourt. So he had not established position. Or actually, cheer. And that's the right call.
Bill Spooner, good call. Take note, Commissioner. I said something good. Keep track. Keep tally.
Rondo. Rondo. Offensive foul. Carlos Arroyo draws the charge. As Rondo picks up his first.
I'm telling you, Rondo couldn't knock me over on the back end. That's terrible. That's a terrible flop. Rondo weighs, what, 150?
A terrible but effective one for Miami. Just over a minute gone by here in the second.
You know, I can't even see terrible anymore. I say terrible, just like Charles Barkley.
Rondo. Rondo to the basket. That time gets all the way, and the Celtics have tied it up.
Well, that's like a big thing for Niles now. Barkley, Bill Walton used to say, terrible all the time.
Chalmers and Arroyo playing together. Haslam left wide open. 6 points for Haslam off the bench.
I think what this unit is important for Miami to not try to do too much. Make the right play and live with the results. That time, pick and roll found Haslam at the foul.
The Heat bench with 14 points. Rasheed Wallace knocks down his first shot of the night.
That's a welcome welcome look for the Boston Celtics. Rasheed Wallace knocking down shots. That's what they brought him here to do.
And that's a nice play by Ray Allen as he got trapped off the catch and shoot to hit Wallace where he could do something with him.
Chalmers fouled on the pass as he goes visiting fans. And Miami will take it out. Foul goes against Wallace. That's two quick fouls on Rasheed Wallace.
So you can shoot that. You're wide open. You're not getting much better than that.
Instead, they get a turnover. Davis to Rondo. Rondo slicing through the defense and draws the foul on Arroyo. Arroyo doesn't like the call, but picks up the personal. And Dwayne Wade's going to come in. Wade with a 2.5 minute break.
Oh, it's just so right, Coach, on the other end. If you get an open shot, shoot the basketball, or you're hurting your basketball team.
Rondo's shot well from the three-point line so far in the series as he makes the first. Reminder, amazing is being here. Season tickets for the 2010-2011 season are on sale now. Go to NBA.com/tickets to reserve your seats. The NBA, where amazing happens. Rondo has had an amazing season. Regular season was an all-star. Set the Celtics single season record for assists, breaking Bob Cousy's record, for steals, breaking Rick Fox's record. Just a spectacular season for him. And he's off to a good start in the playoffs, not scoring wise, but doing everything else.
He was their best player this year.
O'Neal. Foul on the entry pass. That's going to be three now on Rasheed Wallace. Wallace, another player, just fine for his comments about the officiating. He's quiet here. He's picked up three in just 6 minutes. Kendrick Perkins back in. You know, we talk so much about the so-called struggles of Jermaine O'Neal. You got to give a lot of the credit to Kendrick Perkins, who is one of the best defensive centers in the league.
Oh, he sure is. He's a very good defensive center, but conversely, Jermaine O'Neal is more capable than he's played from an offensive at the offensive end. He can make the 17-footer. He can drive by people going left. I mean, he's got, even though he's not a young Jermaine O'Neal, he's still got enough to be a 12, 14 point a game scorer in the playoffs.
He's still only 31. You'd think he's older. He's played 14 years in the league. He's one of those who went right from high school to the NBA. Nice pass, Allen again. Perkins comes up short, gets the rebound, gathers himself, blocked by O'Neal. O'Neal did have 5 blocks in the first quarter of game two. As Wade throws it away. Is it going to be an offensive foul? Nope, they just say out of bounds. And we'll take a break. Boston a 2-point lead early here in the second.
ESPN's presentation of the NBA playoffs. Brought to you by Taco Bell. Think outside the bun. Taco Bell's new premium chicken tortata. Fire-grilled all-white meat chicken in your choice of two bold flavors. It's a whole lot tastier than a sandwich.
Hey, give me that sandwich.
This ain't a sandwich. It's a tortata.
Don't call it a sandwich.
Cargo Incognito. Introducing the Accord Cross Tour from Honda.
It's like a blast of hydration to your face. New Schick Hydro, with water-activated gel that hydrates your skin as you shave and lasts up to twice as long as ordinary strips, while five blades with Skin Guard smooth the skin to reduce irritation. It's the best shave for your skin. The new Schick Hydro. Free your skin.
At LensCrafters, we offer free adjustments, no questions asked, no matter where you bought them. And now, get 30% off eyeglasses and prescription sun. LensCrafters.
If you believe that your relationship with your investments shouldn't be long distance,
join the nearly 7 million investors who think like you do. FaceTime and ThinkTime make a difference. At Edward Jones, it's how we make sense of investing.
Our new low price on Vonage World is going to blow you away. For a limited time, just $14.99 a month gets you unlimited calling to the U.S. and more than 60 countries around the globe. Go to Vonage.com and switch today. No startup costs, no access codes, just free unlimited calling around the world. It's all just $14.99 a month. But this offer ends soon, so go to Vonage.com now or call 1-877-4-VONAGE. Vonage sounds good.
Mark Jones in the studio with his Taco Bell update over on ESPN2, the NFL draft going on. And for those of you wondering about Jimmy Clausen, he was just selected in the second round, 48th overall by the Carolina Panthers. Clausen bypassed his senior season to enter the draft. Colt McCoy still waiting for his name to be called. Mike?
Thanks, Mark. Celtics with a two-point lead with 3.5 gone by here in the second quarter in the American Airlines Arena. Some celebs, current Louisville and former Jeff Van Gundy boss Rick Pitino, watching the action here tonight. And also a couple of Heat players whose jerseys are retired. Number 10, Tim Hardaway, and number 33, Alonzo Mourning. Very reflective right now, the two of those guys right now.
Alonzo Mourning was as good a defender in the paint as any center other than Bill Russell. I never saw him, so I can't really say, but that guy could dominate a game just like Mutombo could. And Hardaway, what a big shot maker.
Alonzo Mourning, we talk about Kevin Garnett, as Davis's jumper is good, and Garnett in his intensity. Alonzo Mourning used to say he had intensity in the layup, and he just played so hard. Celtics, meanwhile, up by 4 now. Wade back in the game, trying to draw the foul on Allen. Does a good job getting away. Looks for the rebound, Perkins. 5 boards for Perkins. Rondo jump shot. Rondo, he's been the big scorer for the Celtics on this 8-0 run. Rondo now with 12 points. He's been distributing double figures in assists the first two games, but they're giving him a shot and he's knocking it down.
In transition, Rondo pushes the ball. No one stops the ball. Rondo, 18-footer, knocks it down. Celtics on an 8-0 run. This is a very improved jump shooter.
Throw this out.
So I was the guy who was never going to have the heart attack. I thought I was invincible. I'm on an aspirin regimen now because I never want to feel that helplessness again.
Be sure to talk to your doctor before you begin an aspirin regimen.
Talk to your doctor and take care of what you have to take care of.
I see trouble coming.
Who are you?
And who are you fighting?
What we ask for is liberty by law.
Go! 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 Go!
excitement to cause unrest, I declare him an outlaw!
Circle your troops and join the charge. Robin Hood, rated PG-13, starts May 14th.
So I see Arby's value menu? It's like kaboom for the buck. Roast beef, curly fries, Jamocha shakes, starting at just a buck. Kaboom! Hey, it's got me coming back.
The Arby's value menu, starting at just a buck. The value menu, only at Arby's.
Access the playoffs on NBA.com. Enhance every game with TV Companion's interactive stats.
Durant straight away behind the three-point line. He drives.
Get comprehensive coverage of every series.
Allen, down both of them. I figured he'll get the ball over his head.
Hear the full story with the most NBA interviews anywhere. Experience all the action and reaction from tip-off to title.
Basketball immortality.
And it's amazing with the 2010 playoffs on NBA.com.
Celtics now with an 8-point lead early in the second quarter. The NBA playoffs continue on ABC Sunday. Two first-round games, first at 1 Eastern. This series, game four, will the Celtics be up 3-0? Will the Heat have it 2-1? Then at 3:30 Eastern, LeBron James and the Cavs. Cleveland up 2-1 after that strong game three victory by Chicago. First round of the playoffs at ABC Sunday. Coverage begins at 12:30 Eastern with GMC Sierra NBA Countdown. Well, Doc Rivers has heard about Joakim Noah talking about Cleveland and the lack of activity there. Josh Smith talking about Milwaukee and the lack of activity there. We asked him about Miami. Would he do the same thing here?
Yeah, I was trying to figure out something negative to say about Miami. I just couldn't find it. It's too nice here. That's the negative part. You know, you don't want to come to Miami because it's Miami.
The road teams in Miami, Dakotas don't like that night off the game before, especially day games, right, Jeff?
Well, that was a very good defensive sequence by Rondo. But I would say this, Mike. If you have a locked-in professional team in the playoffs, you don't mind. But during the year, just chalk that up as an L.
Rondo, you're the man. Give it up, five, buddy.
Rondo would not like the call either. That's his second foul. But now he stays in the game. Wade to Haslam. Haslam short. And Rondo the rebound. Rondo's averaging 7 rebounds a game in the series so far. As Chalmers deflects it out of bounds.
This is textbook individual defense against the dribbler. Making him change, keeping him to the outside, using his feet, showing his hands. That's great defense.
I like the way that the Celtics have picked it up defensively, almost like they see the quit in the Heat. And if I'm Eric Spoelstra, one thing I would think about right now is playing Dwayne Wade at the point guard position and surrounding him with shooters. You've got to find a way to score the basketball. As the Celtics decided to go big, I would go big with Wade at the point.
Allen draws the foul. Well, Miami having that tough stretch here in the second. In this period, they're 1 of 5 from the field with 5 turnovers. We've seen them have good starts. They get into those stretches like they did in game 2, where the Celtics had an 18-0 run and a 21-0 run. Granted, that was in Boston's home floor, but the Heat can be offensively challenged sometimes. Allen knocks that one down. The second quarter was the turnaround in game 2. The fourth quarter was the big turnaround in game 1. Again, good starts in each game, but unable to sustain it. Allen knocks down the pair, and it's now 10 straight points.
Well, you think back to it, game 1, they were up 14 with 7 to go in the third. And since then, it's been total domination.
Richardson, an open look, gets it to go. Boy, do they need that. Eric Spoelstra said, you know, the first 2 games we were mentally tested. In both games we failed that test. They're going to be mentally tested right now. Falling behind. Doc Rivers upset, thought Richardson was out of bounds. 5-point Boston lead. Wade to the basket. Flips it out. Chalmers, extra pass Richardson. The defense from Pierce. Richardson to drive. Stripped by Pierce. 2-on-1 the other way.
Tony Allen, last second pass. Excellent timing. And the Celtics back up seven.
Ray Allen has done a very good job of running the lanes in transition, whether it be for the jump shot or for the finish.
And Tony Allen has been a nice surprise in these playoffs. He's had a nice impact, especially in game one. Wade kicks it out to Beasley. Beasley to the basket. Count it and a foul. Good aggressive move from Michael Beasley for his first field goal.
And maybe that'll be something that will wake up Michael Beasley, because you look on the floor for the Heat, there's only one other guy besides Wade that can score getting out of bed, and that's Beasley. He's got to find a way to become aggressive and take the pressure off of Wade, forcing him to be spectacular every time down the floor.
Free throw off the mark. Just past the midway point here in the second. Game three, Boston up 2-0 in this series. They tip the early. And the foul's going to go against Chalmers. Heat not in the penalty yet. Chalmers picks up his second.
I'm looking at Beasley, and the one thing that so many guys, they get it mixed up. They think, okay, I'm in the league. Things change. It doesn't change. Treat it just like when you're at Kansas State. The same mentality. Go out and handle your business. Be the best player on the floor.
Allen has the height advantage on Chalmers. And Wade the rebound. Richardson. Look at a post up and gets it to go. Richardson was a post up player when he first came into the league. Turned into more of a three-point man. And Doc Rivers wants to talk to his team. Miami had a strong start, led by five. Boston went up by as many as eight. Right now, a three-point game.
Is a frightening man. His daughter is lovely. This little maneuver is entirely ill-conceived. Well done.
It's not about politics or religion. Or the economy. It's not about borders, history, trade, oil, water, gas, mineral rights, human rights, or animal rights. It's not about global warming, global pandemics, globalization, GDP, NATO or Kyoto. It's not about elections, sanctions, proliferations. He said, she said, my land, your land, no man's land. It's not about the stock market, black market, orange alerts, green homes, hope, change, fear or loathing. It's not about communism, socialism or capitalism, war or peace, love or hate. This is about the one month, every 4 years, when we all agree on one thing.
NBA playoffs continue. ESPN Saturday, a doubleheader first at 7 Eastern. The Hawks go into Milwaukee to face the Bucks. They're up 2-0 in that series. Then at 9:30 Eastern, it's the Lakers and the Thunder. Oklahoma City winning at home. What a great atmosphere last night. Lakers still lead the series 2-1. Game 4 should be spectacular tomorrow. First round of the NBA playoffs, ESPN and ESPN3.com. That's Saturday. Dwayne Wade, almost 15 points in the first quarter. Well, what you love about star players is the ability to take over ball games by themselves, getting in the seams, making plays. But also, what separates them is when you're able to make other guys better. You see the Celtics back in transition, building a wall. Well, what am I going to do, says Wade? I'm not going to try to take over one-on-three. I'm going to make a play for my teammate. The on-point pass to Wright, the ability to finish.
Haslam and Wright off the bench, providing a bit of a spark. Richardson just hit a three. Pierce looking to post up Richardson, who has two fouls. Richardson drives, can't get it to go. Good help from Haslam. Wade looking, splits again, up and under. Gets it back as Haslam kept it alive. Inside to Beasley. And Beasley just chucked it up with the right hand and rushed the shot. Rondo, nice move, can't finish. Shooting numbers, 50% for the Celtics, 47% for Miami. Chalmers draws the foul. He gets knocked down and he'll go to the line. Mario Chalmers, a second-year player out of Kansas, was the MVP, or the most valuable player of the Final Four when they won the national title in 2008. A second-round pick in Minnesota, traded to Miami, and as a rookie started all 82 games, made all-rookie second team. They thought he was going to be the starter to begin this season, but his play was a bit sporadic. He's been up and down. He's a good defensive player. Well, if they want him to be more aggressive offensively, Mark, what have you seen from him in his first couple of years in the league?
Well, I thought he took a step back this year. Talking about his first year, he was outstanding. You could see the similarities between him and Rondo. Certainly, ability to disrupt teams defensively and then make plays offensively. He's got to get back with that same level of confidence.
Garnett confidently goes to the basket there. And the Celtics back up by three. Second field goal for Garnett. Coming up on 4 minutes left here of the second. Beasley passes up the jumper, then takes a tougher shot from Garnett on him. Good hustle from Richardson. Beasley gets it back and finishes. Credit Quint Richardson for that bucket.
Well, I'd like to see Beasley take that first jump shot. Don't think about it. Take the open jump shot.
Allen the drive. And he fouled on the pass. That's the 14th foul.
No, here's a guy that's a natural born scorer. Puts the ball on the floor and shoots a contested jump shot. But I like the energy and effort, getting the loose rebound and then finishing. But I'd like to see him much more confident and comfortable on the offensive end. Right now, as young players do, the stakes rises and all of a sudden they forget what got him to that point.
He just picked up his third foul as we check in with Lisa.
Well, Mike, we were talking to Dwayne Wade earlier. Remember, he told us that he believes that Michael Beasley is just thinking too much. He says when he thinks too much, he's just an average player. When he just does his thing, he's a really good player. And Dwayne Wade has publicly demanded more from Michael Beasley recently in the papers, going as far to say just a couple of days ago, he says, look, I'm tired of answering questions. It's about Michael. It's all about him. I was asking Beasley how it affected him. He says, you know, it can shake your confidence to hear that everyone is doubting you and your ability, but I try not to think about it. I've met with Dwayne. We've gone over everything, and I think I'm going to play better.
Well, he said everybody's giving him advice now. He sits down with the three fouls. Wade to the basket this time and throws it out of bounds. Ray Allen took free throws down the other end. I thought that was a pass.
I agreed with you. And also, Wade's got to shoot those. Now he's trying to get... Listen, and I'll be honest. Beasley has fouled three times, two on help. And I really think that at times you just let a guy play through the foul. Because right now, his body language isn't good, his confidence level is not right, and I don't know where he's going to recapture.
Well, this is how you recapture. Forget about meetings with Wade and everybody else. Just show the guy his own resume. Let him take a look at his body of work, what he has been able to accomplish to this point. Sometimes you forget about it. He needs to be reminded of who exactly he is and how to find a way to get it done.
He was the kid at Kansas State in his 1 year at college. He was third in the nation in scoring, scored 26 a game, first in rebounding, 12.4. That's why they selected him second after Derrick Rose. And just
as Wade says, it just hasn't clicked yet for the young man in the NBA.
Well, my bigger issue right now, besides, is 12 usually rebounds translate college to pro. You never notice him getting a traffic rebound, one that where you feel like, hey, that was in traffic right there.
As they call a foul on Wade.
You know, and I just, that's the part of the passion that you can't always just say, I'm going to wait till my offense gets back going to do other things. Rebound the ball. Maybe if you're just pounding the glass, good things will happen.
Well, you think about it. All you got to do is think about last night, watching Oklahoma against the Lakers. Kevin Durant couldn't buy a shot. His offense was missing, but he impacted the ball game by rebounding and making other plays until his offense caught up to him, and then he took over the game in that fashion. That's maturity, and that's getting it done.
Well, you watch a kid like Joakim Noah and just how hard and how passionate he plays all the time.
With not one, even not even close to the skill level from a scoring standpoint, but you always know what you're going to get from Noah. You're going to get competitive play, you're going to get a high basketball IQ, and when the ball's up in the air, he's going to get it. You never question Noah's effort and energy.
Celtics back up by four. Rondo's their leading scorer here in the first half. Good move, Chalmers. And again, the bench continues to do a good job. 18 points for the Miami bench. Garnett lobbed down low, shot deflected. Garnett gets it back. Ray Allen stripped from behind. Chalmers deflection. Chalmers got quick hands on defense. Had a 9-steal game as a rookie. Him and Rondo going at it. A couple of guys with very quick hands. Wade on Allen. Rondo pass stolen by Wade, taken back by Pierce. Shot clock at 5. Allen an open look. Wade again will try. Kicks it back up. Chalmers to the basket, blocked by Perkins. And a quick outlet. Rondo shuffles to Allen. And they're going to wave it off. A foul on Rondo. Dwayne Wade's hustle to get back forced that call.
I would like to see the replay because I don't think that's a foul right there.
Well, the thing is that Wade sold the offensive foul, knew what was taking place.
Wow.
He sold it. Rondo did get into his path that he was coming down the floor.
Well, you can both run. Why can't an offensive player run down the floor?
You have to give that offense, that player like Wade, a chance to change direction. The officials obviously thought that.
Stop already.
Good call. Come on. What? Like, those are the obvious ones to me.
Either way, credit Wade with the hustle to help try and stop
it. He actually delivered the blow to Rondo.
Smart play from Dwayne Wade as Rondo picks up his third foul. Just under two to play on the first half. Heat within two.
Who killed my daughter?
When my daughter died, I quit taking orders.
You can run on for a long time. Run on for a long time. Sooner or later, you gotta.
I have a message to those who stand in my way. Pray.
Cut you down.
Splinter Cell Conviction. Rated M for mature.
Get your special edition Xbox 360 bundle.
Coming up on the Toyota Halftime Show, Mark Jones, Jalen Rose, and Avery Johnson. Not the deciding factor between the Mavericks and the Spurs. They split the first two games in Dallas. And more NFL draft. Mr. Clawson is going to head south. As Dwayne Wade, the first quarter. Second quarter, he sat early. As hasn't scored yet here in the second. He's gotten some help as his Heat team, once trailing by 8, have cut it to 2 and a chance here to tie or take the lead.
But Mike, I think he's been in the paint, Dwayne Wade has, a number of times where he's got to think score first.
Haslam has his shot blocked. Good Celtic defense once again. Pierce to Garnett. Kevin Garnett nails the jumper. Something so impressive in game two without Garnett. Glenn Davis starts, plays well, and they dominate the Miami Heat. Chalmers banks it in. A couple of nice pull-up jumpers from Chalmers.
He played very well, putting them in pick-and-roll situations.
And they're doing it as he's coming off baseline screens, and they're playing Dorrell Wright as like a point forward type.
Pierce.
And Mike, I'm saying this. If I'm Eric Spoelstra, I'm going to give heavy consideration to starting Udonis Haslam in the second half.
He had been so active. Haslam, 6 points, 3 rebounds, and good defense. Chalmers again. Under a minute remaining in the first half. Pierce to Tony Allen. Won't go, and Haslam another rebound. Good pass from Pierce. They just couldn't finish. Tony Allen, a good defender. As Garnett picks him up on the switch. Inside pass to Haslam. Double team. Out to right. Three-pointer. Bang! Miami back up by one.
Great read by Haslam in the paint area, surrounded by Green, delivering the pass on point to right.
Much better ball movement for the Miami Heat here in the first half. Tony Allen. Shot clock at 4. Allen gets inside. Nice pass to Perkins. Knocked away. And the Heat will hold it for the final shot of the half. Wade tries it again. Tried a lob pass, deflected out. And that's it. The first half is over.
Dwayne Wade with an explosive first quarter, but his teammates really helping in the second.
As Miami's bench with 23 points. And they'll head to the locker room with a Miami lead. Wade, 6 of 12. Again, all 15 of his points coming in that first period. He also had 4 rebounds and 4 assists, and he's with Lisa.
Thank you, Mike. Dwayne, you had 15 points in that first quarter, none in the second, but you got some help. What do you like about what you're seeing from your supporting cast?
Yeah, early on I came out attacking, and then they made adjustments. So then I was able to get my teammates some good looks. We got a lot of good opportunities. We got to finish around the basket, but we play well.
What's your mindset as far as taking over? I mean, this is a game three, kind of a must-win for you guys, as far as taking over and or getting other guys involved. How do you balance the two?
Trying to read the game, trying to read the moment. Depending on how I feel as well. So
you look tired, right?
Yeah, you know, playing hard. It's a must-win for us, so I don't need nothing for tonight. I don't need no energy, so I'm gonna leave it all out here.
All right, thank you for your time. Mike.
All right, Lisa. And they bounced back. Celtics went on one of those runs, a 10-0 run. They went up by 8, had the momentum. But the Miami Heat bench, a big part of stopping the run and regaining the lead. As Chalmers, Wright, Haslam, and Joel Anthony also all playing with that kind of energy that Eric Spoelstra has been hoping for. Coming up, the Toyota Halftime Show with Mark Jalen and Avery. They'll take a look at the NBA playoffs, including our second game of our doubleheader, Mavericks and Spurs from San Antonio, plus a quick update on the NFL draft. It's game three of this opening round playoff series. First time the Celtics and Heat have ever met in the playoffs. Boston dominating the first two games. Heat trying to get in the win column. After two quarters, they're up by 1.
Just another perfect day. I think I'll walk this way with the trees that do sing. I'm feeling part of everything. And all my troubles seem to fade away. Skies look brighter.
The hybrid for everyone is here. The Insight. Designed and priced for us all from Honda.
Ladies and gentlemen, the 57th President of the United States.
AT&T, the nation's fastest 3G network. This Mother's Day, get 50% off all messaging phones after mail and rebate, like the Pantech Reveal, only from AT&T.
Hey, what's going on?
Doing the shipping.
Man, it would be a lot easier if we didn't have to weigh them all.
If those boxes are under 70 pounds, you don't have to weigh them. With these priority mail flat rate boxes from the Postal Service, if it fits, it ships anywhere in the country for a low flat rate.
No way.
Nope.
No way?
Yeah.
No way.
Sure.
No way?
Uh-uh.
No way.
Yes way, no way-ing.
Priority mail flat rate box shipping starts at $4.95, only from the Postal Service. A simpler way to ship.
Going up.
Tomorrow, whose dreams will be realized? Join ESPN's All-Star crew for the final rounds of the 2010 NFL Draft. The event continues live from Rainy City Music Hall tomorrow at 10 a.m. on ESPN.
Being able to meet when you want allows you to do a lot more with your day.
I go running with the dogs, and then I do most of my meetings in my running clothes.
You can just be working on it at the same time, and you don't have to be in the same place.
It allows you as a business to be more flexible. It just allows you to do more with less.
Put meetings in their place with GoToMeeting. With one click, GoToMeeting lets you hold online meetings from anywhere. Everyone in your meeting can give presentations and sales demos, edit documents, and collaborate in real time, whether on a PC or a Mac. Hold unlimited online meetings with integrated phone and VoIP conferencing for just $49 a month.
I started GoToMeeting, and now everybody's looking at the same document.
We're able to have the kind of informal dialogue with clients that is like being there.
I use GoToMeeting to reinvent how we do business.
GoToMeeting lets you do things that otherwise you just wouldn't do.
We just couldn't function without it.
Try GoToMeeting free today. Visit GoToMeeting.com and use the promo code SPORTS.
Welcome to the Toyota Halftime Show.
Hopes it with Dwayne Wade at practice on Thursday. He says there are three members of this Miami team that remember what it's like to come back from an 0-2 deficit and turn a series around. They did that in 06 and eventually won the championship. Coach, what do you make of the shot chart here for Wade?
Well, again, Wade is very aggressive. He's shooting a really solid percentage, and he's going to have to duplicate this in the second half. Obviously, when he gets inside the paint, he's really effective.
Dwayne Wade with a big first half, 15 points, and welcome everyone to the Toyota Halftime Show. That's what they're playing for, the Larry O'Brien Trophy. I'm Mark Jones, along with Jalen Rose and the coach, Avery Johnson. Jalen, we saw Dwayne Wade with a spectacular dunk off the rebound. He's averaging about 28 points a game. No one else is averaging more than 10. Quentin Richardson is next. How did they become less predictable on offense?
Well, the key is Dwayne Wade, as you just mentioned, and watching him play is almost like watching a Ferrari or a Lamborghini on a test course, weaving in and out of traffic. The players are cones almost standing still. He's that precise. Now, who's going to be the second best player on this roster to give him a consistent second performer where they can spread the floor, whether it's knocking down shots or an inside presence? In the first half, you saw coming off the bench, Darrell Wright, 9 points, Chalmers and Haslam, 6 points, and that's going to be the key. If he can get team play, if so, they have a good opportunity to win this game.
And what about the Boston Celtics coach, Rajon Rondo, 13 points in the first half. He talked to me about the freedom that Doc Rivers gives him. He loves playing that way. What do you make of his play?
Well guys, we know on our great network, ESPN, the NFL draft is going on.
Uh-huh.
If this guy was in the draft, he would be a first-day pick at quarterback because he knows how to distribute the basketball. He knows how to pass it. He knows how to scramble. And that's what I really love about him. He made the All-Star team for the first time in his career. Great short pass right there to Kevin Garnett. Then he gets out in transition. He knows how to run. He knows how to finish. And then this is the part of his game that I love. He's now pulling up with the little 15-foot jump shot. So again, this is a quarterback. And he can be a quarterback in any sport the way he's playing.
It certainly seemed like the Miami Heat gave it their best punch there, and Boston able to withstand it in the first half, and Miami, though, leading, though, by one at the break. Meanwhile, the focus of the Toyota NBA Sports Nation, the second game of our doubleheader coming up, Dallas Mavericks taking on the San Antonio Spurs. Dirk Nowitzki had 24 points in the last game for Dallas, albeit a loss. He took 24 shots, though, to do it. Dirk talked about the importance of this next one.
I thought in game one we were all over the place, got all the loose balls. And in game two, they were the more desperate team. They wanted it more. It seemed like they got a lot of offensive rebounds. So we got to turn that around tonight if we want to have a chance, especially in this building.
Well, Avery, one of the big turnarounds, a big turnaround story in the last game of that series was Richard Jefferson.
Yeah, you know, when Coach Popovich was talking about his team and after the game one loss, he was using the word dogs, that some of his players played like dogs. So in game one, I guess he was saying Richard Jefferson played like a poodle, so they needed to play more like a pit bull in game two, and he definitely responded. And they need Richard Jefferson to be aggressive. In game one, he had 4 points. Game two, 19 points. The reason they got him was for him to be able to put the ball on the floor, get them baskets when one of the big three or all three of them are getting double teamed. That's why they made the offseason trade for Richard Jefferson, to be able to score on the strong side, get him some easy buckets in transition, and also defend his position, which would be Caron Butler in this series.
He had 17 of the 19 points early in that game, a decisive factor for the Spurs. But the guy since the All-Star break that's been phenomenal has been Manu Ginobili for
the Spurs. Manu Ginobili, no doubt about it. He's a playmaker in the post from three. He does it off the dribble. He really loves pick and roll, and he always makes seem like the right decision, whether it's for himself or for a teammate. And he makes timely baskets, which is the key. Tim Duncan is deciding which side of the screen he wants to set on Jason Kidd. They want to force him right. Jason Kidd takes a bad angle. Manu Ginobili can knock down this shot. While Brendan Haywood is taking a picture, Manu knocks down the three. So that's the key. You have to put pressure on Manu Ginobili and make him work on both ends of the court and see if you could get him guarding Caron Butler. Well, Caron Butler can take some of his legs away, post him up, be physical with him. Because if you allow Manu to go all over the floor and do what he can at will, he'll pick you apart.
But in game two, the Maverick centers combined for 2 points. That's not good. They're going to need to get more they're going to need to be able to get more production out of their centers.
Yeah, Brendan Haywood and Eric Dampier. All right, and fans, log on to ESPN.com, search Sports Nation, and let your voices be heard. We got three games tonight on the ESPN family of networks. And coming up on ESPN2 at 10:30 p.m. Eastern time, it's the Jazz and the Nuggets. Carmelo Anthony and Darren Williams going head-to-head.
The Toyota Halftime Show is brought to you by Toyota. Moving forward. There's a whole new way to travel in comfort and style. Presenting the new Toyota Avalon. It's one smooth ride. It has lots of space for you and all your things.
I got mine with voice-activated navigation.
So we can get to the city.
There's no finer way to travel.
The new Toyota Avalon. Comfort is back.
Ever wonder what it would be like to have monsters and aliens invade your home? We did. Introducing Samsung 3D TV, the world's first 3D LED TV. That's the wonder of Samsung.
Push of a button.
And it shouldn't be made until you order it.
So get ready for seriously tasty supersonic cheeseburger.
It's a big and juicy burger delivered on roller skates from me.
No, me.
Hello, me.
Drive in today and try any supersonic cheeseburger.
Like our new cheddar pepper supersonic cheeseburger. And I'll give you a free medium order of tots. You're gonna love it.
It's big.
It's cheesy.
It's Sonic.
Forward, faster, never looking back. Going up, going down, to the top and to the track.
The energy drink for your feet. Zig-Tek. I get more trained, less pain.
Previously on Deadliest Hunters.
No! These floofs ain't hunters! Now there's something worth hunting! Battle with your friends together on the Wii. Hunting season is open!
Rated teen.
Okay, class. Our special guest is here, Ellen Page.
Hi, Ellen!
We're going on a field trip to China!
Wow. When I was a kid, we would just go to the farm. No, seriously, where are you guys going?
The new classroom. See it, live it, share it on the Human Network. Cisco.
Excuse me, can you hold this?
Oh,
weird. I'm Marty.
Calling all captains!
Drink responsibly.
It gives you a chance to become the ultimate fan. It's the only place you'll find exclusive NBA gear. It's where you can actually put yourself in their shoes. It's the place where you can find your favorite player's jersey. It is the key to everything an NBA fan needs. It's one store, every team.
Welcome back to the Toyota Halftime Show.
Over on ESPN2, the NFL draft in session right now. Jimmy Clauston drafted 48th overall, second round pick by the Carolina Panthers. He had foregone his senior season to put his name in the draft. Colt McCoy, interestingly enough, still waiting to hear his name called. And here's a look at some of the other names that have been selected. Avery Johnson, our Coach Johnson, says that if Rondo was a football quarterback coach, first day guy, right?
Absolutely.
Okay.
Top 10.
Remember, over on ESPN2, that going on in session right now. Meanwhile, 10:30 Eastern time on ESPN2, Deron Williams and the Utah Jazz taking on Carmelo Anthony and the Nuggets. What do you make of this, Jalen?
Arguably the top point guard in the game is Deron Williams.
And Coach Carmelo Anthony, his production dipped a little bit in game two.
Yeah, it dipped not only on offense, but also on defense. He got backdoored a couple of times late in that game against Utah.
And 5 turnovers in game two, 0 in game one. Must take care of the basketball.
Hey, guys, good news for the Nuggets, though. Kenyon Martin says that after missing practice on Thursday, he will play. Coach, I agree with you. Drop back quarterback, huh? Pocket guy?
Scramble guy.
Roll out, Jalen?
I don't know about that. I don't know if he's ready to take a blitz.
The Toyota Halftime Show is brought to you by Toyota. Moving forward. There's a whole new way to travel in comfort and style. Presenting the new Toyota Avalon. For a ride that's jet smooth. It's got reclining rear seats. And such a quiet cabin. Bluetooth wireless audio makes every trip a delight.
The new Toyota Avalon. Comfort is back.
May I help you?
Yes. I hear Progressive has lots of discounts on car insurance. Can I get in on that?
Are you a safe driver?
Yes.
Discount. Do you own a home?
Yes.
Discount. Are you going to buy online?
Yes.
Discount. Isn't getting discounts great?
Yes.
There's no discount for agreeing with me.
Yeah, I got carried away.
It happens to me all the time.
Helping you save money. Now that's Progressive. Call or click today.
Put it all together at Macy's Men's Wardrobe Sale. Buy one suit, get one free from Calvin Klein, Alfani, and more. Dress it up with dress shirts and ties. Buy one, get the second one free. Step out in designer shoes, only $69.99 to $99.99. Play it casual this spring in Tasso Elba Sportswear, 40% off. Plus, save an extra 20% with your Macy's Savings Pass. Macy's Men's Wardrobe Sale. Putting it all together, that's the magic of Macy's.
Nobody really likes to travel that much for work.
5-hour plane travel followed by maybe a hotel room.
The things where you're going to have to get done at home, you know, with your family.
Followed by getting to the actual meeting.
And there's, of course, you know, the time lost while you're gone.
Put meetings in their place with GoToMeeting. With one click, GoToMeeting lets you hold online meetings from anywhere. Everyone in your meeting can give presentations and sales demos, edit documents, and collaborate in real time, whether on a PC or a Mac. Hold unlimited online meetings with integrated phone and VoIP conferencing for just $49 a month.
You could see somebody's idea of moving something on the screen somewhere else, and yeah, that looks way better.
It's less complicated than probably most of the activities you already do on your computer.
I saved a day's worth of travel, probably $1,000 worth of expenses. With GoToMeeting, I actually made money.
It's not only the time savings, it's what's possible now.
It's one of those tools we can't live without.
Try GoToMeeting free today. Visit GoToMeeting.com and use the promo code SPORT.
Now it's time for the McDonald's I'm Lovin' It highlights. Was today's McDonald's I'm Lovin' It highlights.
Halftime of game three from Miami. The Heat with a one-point lead over the Celtics as they try and avoid going down 0-3 in this best-of-seven series. Our Outback Steakhouse first half stats, both teams with good solid shooting. And the turnovers were a problem for Miami in the second quarter, yet they still were able to overcome an 8-point deficit to take the lead. Just a much more aggressive Miami Heat team from certainly where they were in game two. Hi again, everyone, with Mark Jackson and Jeff Van Gundy. Mike Breen on hand. Pretty much for the Heat, Mark, the perfect first half. Wade was sensational for a while, but he got some help.
Well, absolutely. Just what the doctor ordered. You talk about Dwayne Wade early on being the scoring punch for the Miami Heat. Reading the defense. Great job of getting into the seams, whether it be off of transition or half-court sets. One of the best finishes in basketball. And then reading the deep. When they made an adjustment, he made an adjustment. You see four guys in the picture defending Wade. Your job is to create an opening for somebody else to deliver the basketball on point. Once again, high screen and roll. The Celtics decide to get the basketball out of the hands of Wade. Find the open man. When you make the right decisions, when you're down as Haslam, that idea becomes contagious. The open man, three ball corner pocket. Great read by the Heat.
And Wade again, all the points in that first quarter before his teammates picking up the slack in the second. Meanwhile, for the Celtics, Rajon Rondo, who's played so well all season long, really picked his spots beautifully.
Well, he played an efficient first half. Changed speed, was a scorer at times, a distributor. Just a really solid half for what's a very good player.
And he led them in scoring with 13. Also had the three assists, a couple of steals, a couple of rebounds.
And you know, he just kept it simple. When they went under on the pick and roll, he shot the jump shot. When they showed out, he made the right pass. It's just a very simple, efficient half for Rondo.
Rondo, of course, who had that great playoff series last year against Chicago in the first round. That's when Garnett was out. He had to score a lot more. Had those triple doubles. As Pierce operating, contested, shot clock at one. Rondo has to throw it up. He nearly put it in, and Pierce almost got the rebound. Richardson has to get it. I think and a foul's called. The Heat stopped because they thought, I believe it was a 24-second violation. Just stopped going after the ball.
Ray Allen, meanwhile, picks up the foul.
You see O'Neal just walking away. I think he thought that was a shot clock violation.
Yeah, I agree with you.
You can't, though. You just got to keep playing.
Just keep playing. Exactly right. You sound like a coach now, Mike. I agree with you.
Oh, shoot me now. O'Neal with the tough shot. He's one of six, but Beasley on the tip-in.
Good read by Beasley attacking the offensive board. Chris Spoelstra, that's a welcome sight. The young fella getting an easy basket for work and effort.
By the way, I always wanted to be a coach, Jeff. Perkins shot blocked by Wade.
It's the most honorable profession in the world.
Beasley, it's a running start and draws the foul.
By the way, when one of you guys gets a head coaching job, I want to be considered as a top assistant.
Consider this the interview, and my answer is no.
You know, really, what could you bring to a staff? I'm just thinking about that. Your 15-foot jump shot.
A better understanding of how to deal with the officials.
See, I always had a good, my understanding with the officials has always been very good.
No, I'm just kidding.
I'm right, and they're wrong. And we have some guy putting up the bunny ears behind your head.
Unbelievable. And a grown man. I can see if it was a kid. That's a grown man.
That's not a grown man move either. That is a childlike move.
Somewhere his wife is saying, you're better than that.
No, seriously. And I hope, like, they're probably saying, I hope it's the alcohol.
5-point lead for Miami equals their largest of the game. We're 90 seconds into the third quarter. Pierce trying to back down Richardson. Ray Allen, wide open three. And Allen having another good game. 14 points for Allen.
A bad job defensive. You're going to help off of anybody in green. It can't be Ray Allen.
And a foul on the entry pass. Allen picks up his third. A host of players with three. Allen and Rondo each with three. How many times have we seen him take those jumpers? Rarely, though, nobody near him.
And you know why, Mike? That has been worked on early for so many years. He comes early. He shoots jump shot after jump shot. And that's why he's been able to develop that stroke.
Richardson out of the pack. Could have hustled from Paul Pierce to knock it out. But with Allen, it's not just his ability to shoot. He works so hard on getting open.
He didn't have to do that there. They left him open. But you're right. He's great off baseline screens. Knows how to change speed, change direction. And then he can catch and shoot basically off a full speed run, which very few people can do.
Offensive foul, Jermaine O'Neal. A hard screen, and O'Neal picks up his first foul as we check in with Lisa Salters.
Hey, Mike, well, I was talking to Doc Rivers at halftime, and he said that he actually liked a lot about what the Celtics did in that first half. But he said two things have to improve. One, our defense has to get better. And also, he said, we've got to finish. He said, we cannot keep missing these easy shots. We missed seven layups in that first half. So he said, we really can't worry about anything else. We've just got to keep attacking the basket.
Well, he knew it was going to be tough. He was saying before the game, we've only won two games at home. No big deal. Can't get fired up. That's what we were supposed to do. Shot clock down to three. Good Heat defense. Pierce is going to have to put it up as the shot clock expires.
And to me, that's the difference between the two teams. That all three perimeter players for Boston in a late clock situation can create their own shot.
Wade hits a three. Dwayne Wade from downtown. He's got 18.
Talk about creating your own shot. I like that set rather preferably than the one prior to that where they had Wade moving without the basketball. I say put the ball in his hands and let him make play.
Rondo, good second effort as Beasley grabs the rebound. Wade fakes. Beasley wanted a lob. Shot clock down to five. Carlos Arroyo hits a jumper. That's a two-pointer for Arroyo for his first field goal. Carlos Arroyo became the starting point guard late in the season. And his good efficient play helped them reel off those victories down the end as Allen knocks down a three.
Part of the problem for the Heat right now defensively is Dwayne Wade defending Ray Allen. Too often he's falling asleep defensively, and you can't do that against Allen. You got to keep a body on him in position to contest.
Offensive foul. Eric Spoelstra upset, as is Wade, who picks up his second.
You know, we saw earlier possession where Pierce found Allen, and how about this one? Not fighting through the screen, not staying on the body. You give Ray Allen a little bit of airspace, you're going to pay the price.
And think about it. And I like this from a coaching standpoint, Arroyo guarding Ray Allen. Not because Arroyo is a really good defender, but you have to conserve some energy for Dwayne Wade if you're going to expect him to carry the whole entire offensive load.
Arroyo that time picks up the foul. Carlos Arroyo last year was not in the NBA, played in Israel, won a championship for Maccabi Tel Aviv. He's bounced around a bit, six NBA teams. Mark, you played with him in Utah, didn't you?
Oh, he's a big-time competitor, a guy that has extreme confidence, and he's very successful as far as internationally playing the point guard for Puerto Rico.
Wade for the Olympic command. As that shot won't go, O'Neal, the offensive board. Wade sets, fires, hits a three. Second three-pointer of the third. And a five-point lead for Miami.
Coach, you know offensive rebounds kill you. The ability to find a guy on the three-point line, good job by Jermaine O'Neal.
Second chance points have helped the Heat as Garnett That high release.
And that was well defended by Beasley. Shouldn't his head down. He rolled his eyes. Hey, listen, you're going to get scored on this league, in this league. Just go down the other way. You make maximum effort. Just play another good possession.
O'Neal on the pull-up. O'Neal's shooting lows continue. 1 of 7. Now 5 for 31 in this series. Allen poked away by Arroyo. Pierce slides it into Garnett. And it's back to one. Good balance from Boston. 17 for Ray Allen, 12 for Pierce and Garnett, 13 for Rondo.
That was a good decision by Paul Pierce in the high pick and roll. I like his ability to make plays in pick and roll situations.
Rondo, the NBA's deals leader during the regular season, gives the Celtics back the lead. And Eric Spoelstra wants a time. Kevin Garnett and Rajon Rondo putting the Boston Celtics back in front.
Well, good play by Pierce, finding the rolling Garnett. Good finish up over the top. And then against Beasley into the post. Good contest by Beasley, but he's just too long. He can always get off a good look at the basket. Celtics up one.
ESPN's presentation of the NBA playoffs. Brought to you by GMC. We are professional grade. And Vonage. Sounds good. GMC's Truck Month is here. Make each day count. With the truck that offers you over 400 horsepower, almost 1,900 pounds of payload, and up to 10,700 pounds of towing. Get $4,750 total cash back on most Sierra half tons. The truck rated a Consumer's Digest Best Buy. If you've got work to do, Truck Month couldn't have come at a better time.
Our new low price on Vonage World is going to blow you away. For a limited time, just $14.99 a month gets you unlimited calling to the U.S. and more than 60 countries around the globe. Go to Vonage.com and switch today. No startup costs, no access codes, just free unlimited calling around the world. It's all just $14.99 a month. But this offer ends soon, so go to Vonage.com now or call 1-877-4-VONAGE. Vonage sounds good.
It's like a blast of hydration to your face. New Schick Hydro, the water-activated gel that hydrates your skin as you shave and lasts up to twice as long as ordinary strips, while 5 blades with Skin Guard smooth the skin to reduce irritation. It's the best shave for your skin. The new Schick Hydro. Free your skin.
What are you doing, Bob?
I finally figured out how to get my lawnmower to sense precisely the speed I want to walk. It's going to be effortless.
Why don't you just one of these?
Toro Personal Pace Technology. Mowing has never been easier.
Jose Cuervo Silver. Know when to keep it on ice.
This copyrighted broadcast of the National Basketball Association may not be retransmitted, reproduced, rebroadcast, otherwise distributed, or used in any form without the expressed written consent of the NBA.
The Boston Celtics care about the community. Celtics players Rajon Rondo and Sheldon Williams recently visiting students at the Edwards Middle School to encourage the kids to work hard and stay in school. They spoke to the kids about the importance of education and spent time on the court with the group. A fun afternoon for the kids. The NBA, where caring happens. Welcome you back to Miami. Rajon Rondo and the Celtics back up by one. Our GMC Sierra game track. As the Celtics try and go up 3-0 in this best of seven series. Ray Allen once again the leading scorer. Didn't play particularly well in game one offensively. Exploded in game two. Dwayne Wade had the big start. But the key for Miami has been the bench has really helped here in game three.
Star is in the game right now as we approach the midway point of the third. Beasley. Double team Garnett. Practically takes it right out of his hands. 13 turnovers for the Heat. Pierce sets for three. Won't go. And Garnett hit him. Garnett and O'Neal exchange a little extracurricular activity. Garnett gets up and walks away. Their arms got tangled up. Whether or not O'Neal put a little extra oomph into it. Oh, he has a little bit of a throw down.
That's a technical or a flagrant.
Again, it's after the whistle. Normally, you'd see a technical on that. They let it go.
He went with the fake hustle, then pulling him back up.
Good job. He's sold.
Pierce trying to find some room. Good defense from Richardson. Rondo zips a pass. Perkins. Allen fires away. Allen, there it is again. That quick release. 19 points for Ray Allen.
Good unselfish play by the Celtics. Guys turning down shots, putting the ball in the hands of their playmates.
Ray launches a three. That's his third three-pointer of the quarter. Now 24 points for the game.
Think about it. People say, well, bad shot. I say shoot the basketball, Wayne Wade. Make plays, because you're doing the Celtics a favor if you're passive on the offensive end. Your only team, your only hope for your team to win is for you to be the best player on the floor.
And by a wide margin. It can't be like a TKO.
And that's the fourth foul on Quentin Richardson. So Quickie Durrell Wright will come off the bench, as will Chalmers and Joel Anthony.
And I give Quentin Richardson a lot of credit. He always was a competitive defender, but he's got his body back in shape this year. Miami Heat do a great job of getting in condition as a group, but if you don't have an individual commitment like Richardson has to basically save his own career, then you're not going to be rewarded.
He got in shape with all the travel he did this summer. He was traded four times in less than 2 months, as he was traded from New York to Memphis, then to the Clippers, to Minnesota, to Miami, all in the space of 2 months, finishing up here in Miami and becoming a starter on the fourth team he's played for. Started his career with the Clippers, then 1 year in Phoenix, 4 years with the Knicks. As we said, he was a post-up tough player from Chicago and then became a three-point shooter when he went to Phoenix.
But you got to point the finger what you did to the front office and the coaching staff of the Miami Heat. I know what you like to play at, but this is what you're going to play at. You're going to put yourself in position to be in the best possible shape, to be an effective basketball player with this organization.
I agree. There's no reason to tolerate out-of-shape, overweight players. It's a full-time job. And your job as a player is to give your team the best effort. And you only can do that by being in shape and at the right weight.
He lost about 20 pounds during this offseason. Meanwhile, there's blood on the court. That's why the teams went to the benches, cleaning up right now as they're ready to get back on track. Well, we talked about Miami at the very start, Mark, about it was a demoralizing game. Their body language was bad. And, you know, there was some bickering amongst players during the course of the game, but as they've done all season, they've shown some resiliency here tonight. Garnett misses the slam.
And that's what Coach Folsom talked about in the pregame meeting. He said, I have confidence in my team's ability to bounce back.
Wade, not that time. Rondo falls down, gets it to Ray Allen, who's short. Wade gets a running start. Nice bounce pass ahead to Chalmers. And the Heat back up by two.
That's not a nice bounce pass, Mike. That's a nice bounce pass. Two bounce pass to Chalmers, but good look ahead.
Five assists for Wade. He's getting some scoring help tonight from his teammates. The Heat is a team 48% shooting, much improved from the first two games in Boston. Garnett to Allen. And
a foul. Pretty pass. And Ray Allen's scoring in a number of different ways.
Oh, that right there is bad defense by Chalmers. Not fighting, falling asleep defensively. You take your eyes off of Ray Allen, you allow him to have a direct cut lane to the basket, catches the basketball, gets the contact. I tell you one thing I'm taking a look at, and I got to give credit. Beasley is getting the job done defensively. Now, he's struggling offensively, but he's battled against Kevin Garnett on the defensive end, fighting over screens, keeping a body on him, and you like to see that.
Allen hits the free throw. Ray Allen, who said that after the first two games in Miami where they won handily, made him think of back in 2008, the year they won the championship. They won two games over Atlanta easily, then went to Atlanta and lost the next two. He said they can't let that one take care of business right away. Happens so often, Jeff, you talked about it, as Anthony slips in and gets the bucket.
Yeah, that, you're right, Mike. You can't let down subconsciously, and that's excellent pick and roll basketball there. They got to a second pick and roll and found Anthony on the dunk in. Good play by Dwayne Wade.
Pierce on the drive. Misses, ball tipped. Rondo's going to let it go out of bounds, and it's going to be Heat ball. Rondo let it go. He couldn't have gotten it, but he thought it was last touch Miami. By Miami, the officials say he ball. He's still trying to talk to Matt Salvatore. And then down in the front court. Three and a half left in the third. Chalmers splits the defense, lost it, got it back, and he's fouled by Glenn Davis. That's the 14th foul, so Miami gets a new 24.
And that's what Spoelstra was talking about today, or Dwayne Wade was as well. Put your chin and your face on loose balls. Don't be reaching down and trying to pick it up. Good play by the Celtics, good play by Glenn Davis to hit the floor first, but give Chalmers credit for going down there as well.
That's why they won 47 games. They've been a pretty team like that. Had to be. Shot clock at three. Right, nice move. Stripped. Tony Allen got a piece of it. And a 24-second violation. Tony Allen has played very well off the bench in this series for Boston.
Well, he gives them more quickness and more athleticism defensively than they have when they play Michael Finley or Marquise Stanley.
Daniel's not playing much. Nate Robinson not playing much. But Allen, now healthy, playing well at both ends.
GMC's Truck Month is here. Make each day count. With a truck that offers you over 300 horsepower, over 1,800 pounds of payload, and over 20 highway miles per gallon. Get 0% APR for 60 months on Sierra Half Ton. Rated a Consumer's Digest Best Buy. If you've got work to do, Truck Month couldn't have come at a better time.
That's cool. 1,800's poured me a shot. What can your top do? Nothing.
1,800 Tequila. Change the game.
A defining moment in South Africa's history wasn't an uprising or a coup. It was the formation of a soccer league during apartheid by political prisoners who'd lost their freedom but found hope in a game they loved. The same men who would go on to govern the new South Africa and then repay the game by inviting the world to come and play it with them. The 2010 FIFA World Cup on ESPN.
Being able to meet when you want allows you to do a lot more with your day.
I go running with the dogs, and then I do most of my meetings in my running clothes.
You can just be working on it at the same time, and you don't have to be in the same place.
It allows you as a business to be more flexible. It just allows you to do more with less.
Put meetings in their place with GoToMeeting. With one click, GoToMeeting lets you hold online meetings from anywhere. Everyone in your meeting can give presentations and sales demos, edit documents, and collaborate in real time, whether on a PC or a Mac. Hold unlimited online meetings with integrated phone and VoIP conferencing for just $49 a month.
I started GoToMeeting, and now everybody's looking at the same document.
We're able to have the kind of informal dialogue with the clients that is like being there.
I use GoToMeeting to reinvent how we do business.
GoToMeeting lets you do things that otherwise you just wouldn't do.
We just couldn't function without it.
Try GoToMeeting free today. Visit GoToMeeting.com and use the promo code SPORTS.
Mark Jones back in the studio. Time for this Corona timeout. Tim Duncan of the San Antonio Spurs rested, rejuvenated, and resurrected. Coming off a 25-point, 17-rebound performance in a Game 2 win, they look to go up 2-1 in the series. Mavs and Spurs, that's coming up next. Back to you, Mike.
All right, Mark, 3 minutes to go here in the third. Heat leading by one. We've got coaches on the sidelines, coaches in the broadcast booth, and coaches in the stands. Let's go to Lisa Salters.
Hey, Mike, look who I found, Louisville head coach Rick Pitino. Of course, you know he was the coach of the Celtics and the coach of the Knicks. Coach, I wanted to ask you, how many NBA games do you get a chance to get to?
Well, as many playoff games as I could possibly get to. I try to fly around anytime Jeff Van Gundy and Mark Jackson are doing the games. Wherever they're at, I try to make that specific game.
Now, I'm sure everybody else knew this. I just found out that Jeff Van Gundy was your graduate assistant at Providence, correct? And you drafted Mark Jackson. First, let's start with Jeff. What do people need to know about Jeff Van Gundy that they don't?
Jeff Van Gundy slept on my couch in my office to try and beat me to the office every day and did it. A workaholic, great, great young coach at the time. And Mark Jackson was the greatest pleasure I've had in coaching.
Come on, tell us some dirt on the two.
He was pure pleasure. I every day was pure pleasure coaching him. Love him to death.
How about with Van Gundy? You got nothing on him?
Jeff Van Gundy, you know, they fit well, both of them. And I just fly around in my spare time just trying to catch the games that they do. And I tape them at night and I listen to both of them.
You're critiquing their work as well?
Yes, I sit up all night and do it.
Well, thank you very much for your time. And Jeff Van Gundy was saying during the break, tell Coach that he looks good.
Yeah, I'm 41 now. I look great. Thank you.
Thank you, Coach.
Boy, that is not what we wanted out of Coach Pitino.
Hold on. I can just tell you that Coach Pitino and I had two different experiences coaching Mark Jackson. Pure pleasure or pure torture, okay? It was pure, all right. Hey, you're still believing what he told you when you were a rookie, that you were better than Magic Johnson.
Let me tell you something. Everybody knows how I feel about you as a coach. Outstanding coach. With all due respect, Rick Pitino is the greatest coach I've ever had. You're talking about a guy that is absolutely was a joy for me to play for. My career could have gone a totally different way. And like you said, I love that guy to death.
This love fest is making me sick.
No, but you know what? As Tony Allen takes an ill-advised three.
And a foul on Haslam.
But when it comes to players, like Dwayne Wade would have been a great player no matter who he played for. But you, because it's all in the eye of the beholder, had to be given a chance. And when a coach believes in a player like you who has high basketball intelligence but may lack some athletic skills, hey, then you're allowed to play to your strengths, and that's what Rick Pitino did for you.
Go off the loose ball foul from Haslam. Davis to the free throw line.
And I'll give you permission to take out the May lack some athleticism. I'll give you permission to take out the May.
It's all about softening the blow.
Game tied at 70 with 1:39 remaining here in the third.
You see the thing, though? He shows us all sorts of love. You're not going to see that on E60. No. You got to see the up. You can't. Lisa tried to drag him into it. He showed us love, but that wasn't good enough.
No, there's no controversy. He just fired me about every other day for a full year. But, you know, other than that, there's no controversy.
Wade. Wild pass to right. Rondo deflects it, goes back to Wade. Short. And Rasheed Wallace to rebound. Surveying the situation. Nearly stolen by Thomas. Shot clock at 6. Pierce pulls back, hand in his face, knocks it down. Celtics by 3. Final minute of the third quarter. Chalmers, Wade, Joel Anthony, Durrell Wright, and Haslam out there right now for Miami. Rondo with another steal. Fakes back to Pierce. And Pierce banks it in and a foul. Pretty play from Rondo.
providing the opportunity for Pierce.
Great job of trapping off the pick and roll, active hands, active bodies, and then Rondo once again, rather than challenging Dwayne Wade, waits for the trailer. Pierce, bigger, stronger, the ability to take the hit and finish at the rim.
And who started it at the other end? It was Tony Allen again. He's just been so active in his time off the bench. And Pierce, a technical foul called on Dwayne Wade. One shot technical, then the Heat will get the ball back. Eric Lewis teeing him up.
And Wade actually upset, feeling like Rondo held him down after he passed the basketball to Paul Pierce in transition. And I like what Udonis Haslem is doing right now. Dwayne Wade is too valuable to this basketball team to allow him to get into a shouting match with the referees.
A 12-point turnaround here in the third. The Celtics were trailing by five. And now they lead by seven. An 8-0 run is the current run as we wind down the third period. Wade to the basket, up and under, gets it to go. 28 for Wade. That was an angry drive.
And well timed for the 2-for-1 situation. They'll have about an 8 or 9 second differential coming back.
Pierce wants the ball against Wright. Pierce puts up the three. Too strong. Rebound. Rajon Rondo, another board. His sixth of the game. He had 7 in game 1 and 7 in game 2. Pierce just holding. Pierce puts up the three and puts it in. Big shot from Pierce with 1.7 remaining.
He did that same thing at the end of the first quarter.
Wade gets it at the buzzer. A little too strong. And the Boston Celtics finish strong here in the third quarter with an 11-2 run, Mark.
Bad defense by Wright to close out quarter, allowing Paul Pierce to step in rhythm for knockdown jump shot. Pierce carried the Celtics at the end of that third quarter.
Ray Allen having another big game with 22. Dwayne Wade, of course, leading the Heat. And Pierce with his best game so far with 21.
Moving without the basketball, you fall asleep, you pay the price. Dwayne Wade trying to keep his team in this ball game, offensively carrying the load. Celtics up 8.
You got the pirate paper plates, the pirate cake, pirate balloons. You even got them a real...
Yeehaw!
Cowboy. The party company sent you a cowboy. Well, moment of truth, Mom. Which 3G network do you trust to go to Bing to find a pirate character? This Mother's Day, get Mom a great gift for under $30, like the BlackBerry Curve for $29.99. When you want your 3G network to work...
Let's party!
You want Verizon.
40. See? Told you there were 40 shots in there.
But you also said there's going to be a reverse ventriloquist act here.
Excuse me, guys.
Calling all captains!
Drink responsibly.
One a day Vita craves. A complete adult multivitamin in a gummy to support energy, immunity, and your inner child. One a day Vita craves. Multivitamin gummies for grown-ups.
GMC's Truck Month is here. Make each day count. With the truck that offers you over 400 horsepower, almost 1,900 pounds of payload, and up to 10,700 pounds of towing. Get $4,750 total cash back on most Sierra half tons. The truck rated a Consumer's Digest Best Buy. If you got work to do, Truck Month couldn't have come at a better time.
I've been waiting for you, honey. You know why? Because I got something you may not have tried at Popeye's. You know how much you love to sit down with my bona fide chicken? Well, my all-white meat Louisiana tenders are times when you're on the move. Right now, you can get 2 tenders, a biscuit, and a side for just $2.99, or 9 bona fide pieces for $7.99. My love that chicken from Popeye's flavor in my one-of-a-kind Louisiana tenders.
Can I help you?
He'll have the tenders.
Louisiana!
Hey, losers! Time.
This spring.
I got a great feeling about this one.
Critics are calling the losers a winner.
You hear that?
It's a hot, sexy, exciting ride.
We gotta stay focused on this show.
Absolutely.
The perfect mix of laughs and action.
Good times.
Hit it.
Oh my God!
I'm the Black MacGyver. MacGyver.
The losers. Ready PG-13. Now playing.
Three-pointer out front.
The first trio of brothers to all have World Series rings.
Faith and hope and charity.
Get in here! 1-0 by it!
You get three. That's the magic number. Three.
Now three will mean even more to sports.
Fourth quarter set to begin in Miami. The Heat down 2-0 in the series, down 8 here in game 3. As it's now time for our Vonage Coach's interview with Lisa Salters.
Thanks, Mike. Coach, a 13-point turnaround. You guys were up by 5, now down by 8. What changed in that quarter for you?
Well, we just got to keep on coming defensively. They're making a lot of shots. End of the clock, end of possession, offensive rebounds. We got to finish it.
Dwayne Wade was telling me at the half, got to leave it all out on the floor. He looked tired at times in that third quarter. How will you play him coming down the stretch?
Probably not much time for rest right now.
All right, thank you very much.
No question, not going to be able to rest much. He'll start the fourth quarter on the bench. You see, he's got the 28. Again, Wade doing the majority of the scoring. Meanwhile, nice balance from the Boston Celtics so far.
I think if I was Eric Spoelstra right now, I'd get the ball across half court and take another timeout to give him more rest and then get him right back in.
One of the problems for the Heat, Jeff, we were talking during the commercial, turnovers. They're one of the best during the regular season. As Rasheed Wallace fouls Chalmers, they were fourth in the NBA in fewest turnovers per game, but they've got 16 through the first three.
Well, and one of the reasons why, Mike, is because everything's a struggle other than when it's in Wade's hands. And you're going up against a quality defensive team like Boston. It's difficult, and thus you're going to get more late shot clock situations and more turnovers.
Arroyo and Chalmers, the backcourt. Chalmers, a high arcing three. This hits the rim, and Davis the rebound. Davis coming off the bench. You have to start game two because of the suspension to Kevin Garnett.
From the Miami Heat, down 2-0 in a crucial game three. This is not the lineup I'm starting the fourth quarter with.
Ball knocked out of bounds.
To me right now, Beasley's got to come through. He is the only guy, other than a pick and roll situation, that can go and get his own. Because, listen, it's time to deliver. This is what you do. Do it.
And he's being defended by Glenn Davis. Give him the basketball and make a play.
Chalmers on the drive. Lost it. Got it back and banks it in. Tough play from Chalmers. He thought he got hit. Did a good job finishing.
This is a group that also, they've got to get it done on the defensive end. Get stops, get the basketball, and push.
Oh, Rondo, that pretty ball fake, and the lead back up to 8. It is crunch time for the Miami Heat. You don't want to fall down 0-3. Everyone knows no team in NBA history has won a series after trailing 3-0. Haslam lost it, picked up by Beasley. There's that soft touch.
And defensively, whoever is guarding Tony Allen's got to give support if Miami falls back in a 2-3 zone.
Houston Davis. Houston gets a good open look and knocks down another three. 24 for Pierce. And Eric Spoelstra calls time as his team goes down by 9. Largest lead of the game.
And really missed assignments. You talk about going zone, you have to realize who could hurt you on the offensive end. Leaving Paul Pierce wide open in the corner. Your job is to stay at home. You know the rules. Hand down, man down.
Pierce had 16 points in game one, 13 in game two. He's had a huge effort with 24 here.
ESPN's presentation of the NBA playoffs. Brought to you by the all-new 2011 Super Duty, built Ford Tough.
Look, the guy at the gas station ain't waving to you because he's your friend. Guess what? He's got his hand in your wallet. He makes money on gas. You lose money on gas, okay? So here's something to wipe that smile off his face. Introducing the all-new 2011 Super Duty. Now with two all-new Ford-built engines. Gas or diesel, they've got the most horsepower, the most torque, and they've also got the best fuel economy. Hey, who's your friend now? The all-new Super Duty.
Layer upon filling layer of the good stuff for just 89 cents. Taco Bell's beefy five-layer burrito, loaded with seasoned beef, cheddar cheese, and a hidden layer of nacho cheese sauce. It's a hefty half-pound burrito for just 89 cents only at Taco Bell. Why pay more?
Hey. Hey, Katie, how are you?
Should I get a perm?
Ooh, that's an interesting question.
She's always talking to me in meetings. I mean, it's just so rude.
When did video meet dancing?
Posting it.
Do not post this. I'm not going to grow a beard because then I'll look ridiculous. Where am I? By the way, Katie, Tillamook is beautiful this time of year.
Oh, really? We should go camping.
AT&T 3G. Talk and surf at the same time. This Mother's Day, get 50% off all messaging phones after mail-in rebate, like the Pantech Reveal, only from AT&T.
DVR Challenge on.
Tell the truth.
Welcome back. These three television providers claim they have the best DVR. Who will you believe?
A couple years ago, a website voted our DVR the best.
That's on the internet.
Well, our DVR stores twice as much as theirs, and you can program it from any cell phone.
Get out.
Ours literally does none of that.
Judges?
Nothing again?
I'm getting smoked.
Now that you've got the truth, get DirecTV. Stay tuned.
As NBA players, we definitely have our differences.
We come in all shapes
and sizes.
Pero no importa que diferentes seamos,
there's one thing that brings us together.
Teamwork. It works the same way in our communities.
Here we go.
By working as a team, there are no limits to what we can achieve.
Now that's the kind of team I'm talking about.
Teamwork. Together.
NBA playoff action continues tomorrow night on TNT. Orlando trying to go up 3-0, but they're now in Charlotte for game three. Phoenix trying to take a commanding 3-1 lead. They're up 2-1, game four in Portland. Then ABC Sunday, game four of this series. And then game four of Cleveland at Chicago. Bulls getting the victory in game three. And NBA TV on Monday, Atlanta in Milwaukee, game four of that series. Will the Heat be down 0-3 on Sunday, or are they going to have the big comeback?
Well, and you're talking defensively. They've been a great defensive team all year, but not this way. Dwayne Wade on Ray Allen, he's got to be on his body instead of trying to shoot the gap. And then against the zone, the last possession, Rasheed Wallace, good little brush screen. But this is just unawareness by Michael Beasley of what your responsibility is and who can hurt you on the floor. Paul Pierce wide open for the three-point corner shot.
Okay. Rondo, excellent harassment, but got a little over-aggressive and picks up his fourth foul.
But that's how you have to attack pressure, though, is go by it. You can't play around and let him push up on you. Good play by Chalmers.
You make a great point, because I found myself in playoff situations being pressured by Scottie Pippen or Kobe Bryant, and you still try to run the sets. Your job is to forget about the sets and make a play if you're being pressured like that. Wade tied up. Shot clock at six. Right on the drive. Kicks it out. Beasley, a good open look. And again, Beasley gets it to go. He's got 12 points.
That's a good play by Wright. Putting the ball on the floor, recognizing the clock, and then finding Beasley.
Pierce has had a big game. Wade deflects it. A lot of contact. Here comes Wade the other way. And it's back to five. Pierce thought he got fouled. Wade with 30. Crowd gets into it a bit. Wallace double team, gets it to Allen through the hands of Davis, but he gets it back. And Pierce was out of bounds when he caught it. All of a sudden, the momentum has shifted just a bit.
Well, again, they're playing 2-3 zone. Big Baby Davis, good hands by Dwayne Wade.
into a good finish. And the crowd's finally into it. They've had some quiet moments here tonight.
Yeah, like the first 3.5 quarters. This is the most dead playoff crowd I've been around in a while.
Wade, nice pass, setting up Haslam. Haslam can't hit, and Pierce the rebound. Rondo will walk it up. Pierce the drive. Offensive foul. Haslam, who's one of the best in the NBA at drawing charges, brings about Pierce's third personal.
Veteran play. Missed a shot on the other end, not shaking his head, not thinking about it. Gets back on the defensive end, and little things mean a lot. Get in position, take the hit, offensive foul by Pierce. Outstanding job by Haslam, sacrificing his body.
A Miami native, one of the players who was on that 2006 championship team, fighting here in the fourth quarter. Wade. Beasley left open again. He has got such a smooth jumper, and it's a three-point game.
So they make the adjustment. Rather than having Haslam set the pick, they bring up Beasley. Now you got two guys that can score, and then it's pick your point.
Seven assists for Wade. Rondo and Garnett. Pierce on the pull-up. Tough shot. Boy, Pierce, he looks so strong tonight.
Coach, when he's playing this well offensively, there comes a point when you have to trap him and force him to get rid of the basketball from pick and roll.
It's either a trap or a switch, but you got to make sure he's covered as he comes off the pick.
Beasley feeling it. Again, Michael Beasley with four buckets here in the fourth quarter.
No, Mike, that's just what we talked about. Those are the shots he was turning down early in the ballgame. He's a knockdown shooter and a big-time scorer.
Rondo misses. Rebound tipped. Wright comes up with it. And a whistle and a loose ball foul against Glenn Davis. He yells at Bennett Salvatore. He's better be careful. Michael Beasley, 8 points through the first three quarters. 8 points already here in the fourth.
Finally, a Michael Beasley sighting. You're talking about getting it done. You were born a scorer, son. Do you. Check your body of work. Glenn Davis daring you to be a shooter. Knocks down the shot, and all of a sudden has a swagger about it.
And I think right now, if you're the Celtics, you have to make Beasley put it on the floor and see if he can finish over the length of Garnett and the strength of Perkins.
Wade, the runner, can't get it to fall. And Pierce comes the other way. Pierce pulls up. Haslam, outlet deflected by Garnett. Ball loose, and players crash into each other. Beasley and Wade first knocking each other, and then Pierce getting involved. Terrific hustle from both teams. Let's see whose ball. They say it's Celtic ball.
Hey, but good effort by Beasley and great deflection by Kevin Garnett on the outlet to prevent that layup.
Dwayne Wade upset because he felt like on last dribble penetration there was contact by Ray Allen. Those are calls that he's used to getting and upset that he did not get that one.
Celtics holding on to a three-point lead. Neither team was led by double figures. Largest lead is 9. That was Boston earlier in this period. Still plenty of time remaining. They're playing off Rondo. Garnett posting up Haslam, turnaround jumper, knocks it down.
And again, there's nothing the smaller Heat can do on that. It's just make or miss for Garnett. Again, well defended, but Garnett's length wins out.
Wade for three. Rebound Beasley trying to keep it alive, knocked out of bounds. Last touch by Perkins.
And Mike, what Mark was talking about, passion. Beasley chasing the loose ball down, chasing the rebound down. Then the game becomes easier when you're fully invested.
You're just making things happen right now. 2:24 for Miami. Coming up in the midway point of the fourth quarter. Darrell Wright to drive. Wild shot, not a good one. Garnett the rebound. Rondo. Offensive foul. After pass, Pierce. Or is it Perkins? Either way, it's Miami ball as Perkins picks up his second. And we'll have a timeout.
Even though they're sagging up Rondo, he enters the ball to Perkins. Good back in, a little dream shake, turns to his right shoulder, and there's just nothing the smaller Udonis Haslem could do to impact that shot. That's been his shot ever since he came in the NBA.
Chances are, if you're towing 12 tons of something, it's probably pretty important to you. That's your livelihood back there, okay? So you're gonna wanna keep it from swaying back and forth like hippies around a campfire. No sweat. Introducing the all-new 2011 Super Duty. It's got the most towing power and now an advanced trailer sway control system. And it's standard. Yeah, that'll take the white out of your knuckles. Kumbaya, baby. The all-new Super Duty.
Our new low price on Vonage World is going to blow you away. For a limited time, just $14.99 a month gets you unlimited calling to the U.S. and more than 60 countries around the globe. Go to Vonage.com and switch today. No startup costs, no access codes, just free unlimited calling around the world. It's all just $14.99 a month. But this offer ends soon, so go to Vonage.com now or call 1-877-4-VONAGE. Vonage sounds good.
In Australia, we always have a fresh take on life and everyone's invited to the barbie. And at Outback Steakhouse, that same fresh spirit inspires everything we do, like our extra-large snow crab legs, freshly steamed, sweet, succulent and bursting with crab meat, served with our tender signature sirloin set to perfection just the way you like it. All for a way down under price of only $13.95. Once you've tasted fresh, mate, you'll never settle for anything less. It's always fresh in the Outback.
It's a great car. Show me the Carfax.
I'll give you $500 off.
Show me the Carfax.
I'll throw in the oil changes.
Just show me the Carfax.
A Carfax report can help you choose a great used car. It's free at thousands of reputable dealers. Just say, show me the Carfax.
At LensCrafters, we offer free adjustments, no questions asked, no matter where you bought them. And now, get 30% off eyeglasses and prescription sun. LensCrafters.
Mark Jones back in the studio with his Ford update. Well, after an uninspiring Game 1 performance, San Antonio responded with an impressive win in Game 2. The four-time NBA champs tried to fight off Dallas in a battle of Texas. Mavericks and Spurs coming up next.
All right, Mark, that should be a good one as the NBA playoffs continue on ABC on Sunday. A couple of more games. Celtics and Heat game 4. Will Boston have command or will the Heat be back in it? And then the Cavs and Bulls game 4 from Chicago as the Bulls try and tie things up with the team that has the best record in the NBA. The Boston Celtics trying to hold on to what was a 9-point lead. Very active, always good communication with the veterans.
So you want to be a championship team, don't just rely on the guy in the suit and tie. Begin to hold each other accountable. Have discussions on how you're going to find a way to get it done. That's true leadership, and that's by committee.
And you know what I like about that? Even the guys who haven't gotten in, Marquise Daniels, Sheldon Williams, and others, are actively involved, listening, and not separating themselves from the team as a defensive 3-second violation is called.
So now a one-shot technical, defensive 3 seconds for the casual fan, as you can't be in the paint on defense for more than 3 seconds unless you're closely guarding your man, which is usually within arm's distance. So the one-shot technical makes it a 4-point game. Wright will inbound. Wade, Wright, Haslem, Beasley, and Chalmers. Chalmers on the attack. Knocked away. Tries to get it back and does. Feeds Wright. Wright bounce pass inside. And a foul. Miami Heat trying to force some passes in. And they get a little break there, and they'll get some free throws.
And Mike, part of it is because they don't feel comfortable trying to finish over the length of Garnett and of Perkins. So when Chalmers initially drove, there was no need for him to pass. Keep going to the rim until the defense commits to you.
And here's what I like. Dwayne Wade pulling Chalmers aside, talking about the same point that you just made. Your job is to be aggressive. If I put you in position to shoot the basketball, make a play, trust your game. Don't make mistakes because you're too passive.
Haslam with a chance to cut it to two. Haslam, a strong game off the bench.
I'm going to tell you, the teacher wasn't happy with the student's answer.
Starting five in there for the Celtics. Pierce. Garnett, one dribble, jump shot is good. Garnett's had a good game, 16 points.
It's an outstanding screen by Kendrick Perkins right there to free up Garnett.
We're seeing glimpses of the old Kevin Garnett. You talk about post play, you talk about knockdown jump shots. I'm sure the Celtics are happy to see this.
Wade trying to draw contact, it's a down. 32 for Wade, back to three again.
And once again, Wade upset. That's contact by Ray Allen on the shot attempt. That should be basket and a foul.
But I think that was correctly called right there. I thought Wade created the contact.
Pierce deflected by Wade. Perkins gets it. Perkins gets knocked down. Shot clock down to five. A backcourt violation. Now Bennett Salvatore says, wait a minute. And it's going to be Miami ball.
Yes, it wasn't deflected. He was fouled on the pass. They grabbed his arm, I believe. If we see that again.
If it's deflected, you can go back and get it. Yeah, he looked like he got hammered. I think it's deflected.
No.
No, it wasn't. So the backcourt violation is correct, but it looked like he got hit. Way to Beasley. Beasley inside. Won't go. And Pierce the rebound.
Sometimes you just got to finish over the size. Go right through it.
Nice play from Darrell Wright to knock it away. Beasley saying, get out of the way. Now he's doubled. Wade on the drive. The runner drops in. 1-point game. And Wade comes up hobbling. What a performance from Wade. 34 points, 7 assists. Ray Allen wide open, can't hit, and a loose ball foul on Paul Pierce. And the Miami Heat will shoot free throws for the lead.
Trying to close out a ball game. Dwayne Wade making plays time and time again, getting into the seams. Beautiful floater in traffic. That's a big-time finish.
Wade getting his calf rubbed. Don't know if it's a cramp, but he's over there right now. Is Wright will shoot the free throws. Wright has played very well off the bench. Ties the game.
And, Mike, Mario Chalmers has to do a better job on Ray Allen. He was wide open again because Chalmers, instead of staying on the body, is trying to make it up and shoot the gap, and it's leaving Ray Allen wide open.
And in the middle of all of this, Chalmers walks down the floor, talks to Wright and Beasley, and trying to tell them how to defend it. At the end of the day, if I'm Beasley or Wright, I say you got to keep a body on Ray Allen. Forget about the excuses. Keep a body on him and trail him. No more excuses. Find a way to get it done.
Darrell Wright gives Miami the lead. A 16-6 run. They were down 9 with 9.5 to play. Now the Heat by 1. Trying to avoid going down 0-3. And a foul as Rondo gets knocked to the ground. It's only the first team foul for the Miami Heat. Meanwhile, it's the fourth for Wade.
And that's a difficult play because Haslam's fronting Garnett, Wade sagging. So when Rondo put it on the ground, that's a hard cover for both Wade and Haslam to give the proper help.
Rondo, they give him an open look, takes it to the basket, running shot won't go. Beasley snatches the rebound.
And this is the rebounding that Michael Beasley has to bring every night.
Wade, the spin move inside, won't go. And Garnett, the rebound. Now they're saying Eric Lewis is saying goaltending, that it was touched above the cylinder. Or is he saying offensive interference?
I think he ruled offensive interference.
Spoelstra thought it was the defense, but no. Nope.
What a beautiful move.
Grabbed the rim after it bounced off.
Grabbed the net. Now, if you pull the net down hard, would that impact the shot, like snap the rim?
Absolutely. I think he felt that Wade was the one that hit the net. And Pierce is fouled, so he'll go to the line. Now, if you hit the net and it doesn't cause any problem in terms of the ball going in, which this doesn't seem to be, and that's Wade with his hand on the rim.
Well, you don't know which one impacted the rim being pulled down. But I'm sure the officials would love to see it in super slow-mo like that, too.
So Pierce to the free throw line. He's 5 of 6. Misses that one. This is the first game of our Friday night doubleheader coming up. Game 3 from San Antonio. Dirk Nowitzki and the Mavs all tied up with the Spurs 1-1. As they split the first two in Dallas. No set split here in Boston Celtics. Two impressive wins, but right now trying to take a commanding 3-0 lead. Tie game again.
I like what the Heat are doing offensively. It's strictly been high pick and roll with Wade and Beasley, living with the result of your two best offensive guys and Wade being the decision maker.
Right, fakes, drives, kicks it out. Haslam wide open, knocks it down. Beat by two.
Excellent play by Wright by driving it hard to the rim. Garnett had to come all the way to him, and that's why Udonis Haslam was wide open.
Darrell Wright has been huge off the bench. 12 points, 5 assists, 4 rebounds. Ray Allen, the quick three. That's good. Ray Allen puts the Celtics back up by one.
And that was well defended by Chalmers, and Chalmers needed Beasley on that to stunt or show out to prevent the rhythm jump shot.
Wright nearly lost it. Fakes and drives again. Haslam, and he's fouled by Perkins. That shot won't count. And Haslam will go back to the free throw line. And we'll have a timeout with 2:10 remaining. And the Heat trailing by a point.
The athleticism of Ray Allen to plant, change directions, coming up full speed, balance up, and knock in a three. There is no defense for the catch-and-shoot three. Chalmers did an outstanding job there. Ray Allen, one of the all-time best.
Okay, if you're one of those round-the-clock, we-never-close, 24-7 types who doesn't get paid until the job gets done, the last thing you need is a truck that doesn't have the stones to bring home the Benjamins. No problem. Introducing the all-new 2011 Super Duty. Thanks to its all-new Ford-built Power Stroke diesel, you get it all. The most horsepower, the most torque, the most payload, the most towing, and the best fuel economy. It's payday. The all-new Super Duty.
One a day Vita Craves, a complete adult multivitamin in a gummy to support energy, immunity, and your inner child. One a day Vita Craves, multivitamin gummies for grown-ups.
Excuse me, can you hold this? That's weird. I'm Marty.
Calling all captains!
Drink responsibly.
Ever wonder how amazing it would be to experience life in another dimension? We did. Introducing Samsung 3D TV, the world's first 3D LED TV. That's the wonder of Samsung.
the new BK Breakfast Muffin Sandwich. It's not that original, but it's only a buck. Now at Burger King.
It might have been named 2010's top vehicle in its category, if it had a category. Discover the Can-Am Spyder Roadster. Its three-wheeled stance is unlike anything else on the road. See what thousands of riders already know at canam.brp.com. It's riding reinvented.
NBA playoffs continue on ESPN Saturday with a doubleheader. First at 7 Eastern, Hawks and Bucks from Milwaukee. Atlanta up 2-0 in that series. Then the Lakers and Thunder from Oklahoma City. Lakers still with a 2-1 lead after that thrilling victory for the Thunder last night. Meanwhile, here in Miami, the Heat trying to get the victory and stay alive in the series and avoid falling behind 0-3. They trail by one. Michael Beasley has been huge in the fourth quarter.
Well, they needed him, and he certainly has stepped up. You're talking about free throw, jump shot. You're talking about isolation, trusting his basketball game, jab, step, jump shot, and then defensively secure the basketball. That's a go-get-it rebound. Beasley certainly swing up for the Heat.
He was the number two scorer in the team in the regular season. Has been up and down, as we said earlier. He's the lightning rod here in Miami. When the team doesn't play well, he tends to take the criticism. He's a young player trying to figure it out and try and become worthy of that number two pick. He's still just a kid in many ways. He's so young, but he has come through here in the fourth quarter. He's 21 years old. Meanwhile, the veteran with a chance to both eat back up. Haslam, huge off the bench, 9.7 rebounds, and misses the free throw. The Heat trailed by 9 with 9.5 to go in the fourth quarter. We're tied again. 14 lead changes and 13 ties. 2 minutes remaining. Fourth quarter here, game 3. Good ball denial from Chalmers.
And he ran through that double screen like he wanted to win.
Pierce. Wright tries to stay with him. Pierce can't connect. Rebound, Rondo. It does it again. Sets up a 3. Pierce puts in the 3. 30 points for Pierce, and Rondo's 8th rebound, huge.
And it's the second 3 Pierce has got right off a second shot, and Rondo, Wade has to block out there.
9 points in the fourth for Pierce. 3 down the other end, that's good. Darrell Wright with a huge game. We're tied again with 1.5 minutes to play. 15 big points for Wright. Ray Allen for 3. That won't go. Rebound Perkins. Another offensive rebound. And Pierce, not that time. Haslam the rebound.
And here's where coaching comes in. Get the ball to Wade and get out of his way.
That's a good system right there. I like your thinking. And I'm not even sure I'd put him in a pick and roll.
Crowd on its feet. Haslam the drive. The pull up won't go. Pierce the rebound. And the Celtics call timeout. With 45.3 remaining in a tie game. Haslam loved the look, does not like the result. Terrific end-to-end action here in game 3. Miami Heat trying to get the come-from-behind win.
Many will hear the calling.
Move it! Yes, sir!
Few will earn the title United States Marine. The few, the proud Marines.
Just because it says for men doesn't mean it is. New Gillette Odor Shield Body Wash targets and neutralizes odor for up to 16 hours. Because you've got a man-sized odor,
hanging all over you. Gillette Odor Shield Body Wash. Wash like a man, be like a man. Also try new Gillette Odor Shield Antiperspirant.
Continues from San Antonio. In a couple of minutes, it's going to start on ESPN Classic, Game 3 between the Mavericks and the Spurs. We've got Game 3 here in Miami, and Dwayne Wade getting some help. A number of players making some big plays in what's a tie game. It's Celtics ball right now. As you see the timeouts remaining, both teams with multiple timeouts, Heat with a foul to give. You see Durrell right in that huddle. Boy, has he played huge for Miami.
Well, big time plays. How about offensively? Wade does not always have to be the hero. Trust the guys around you. He falls asleep, delivers the pass on point and on time to right in the corner, knocks down a game tying 3-point.
He had 2 points in game one, 2 points in game two, but has come up in a big way in the fourth quarter in game three.
And coach, if I'm the Celtics right now with 46 seconds to go on the clock, I'd like the feeling of designing a quick hitter set where you have the opportunity to go 2-for-1 and get the basketball back.
And you want to get that shot up at around 30 seconds.
Allen comes off the screen. Rondo delivers. Allen for three. Short. Ball knocked out of bounds. And it's Miami ball. Rondo almost had another offensive rebound.
Again, I think poorly defended by Chalmers, trying to shoot the gap, and Wade not really paying as much attention to Rondo as maybe he should.
Boy, Rondo just all over the place.
And coach and I talked about this. We'd much rather have a 1-4 where Wade has the ability to make a play.
Wade is at 34 points tonight.
And I wouldn't run the clock all the way down because they're going to get a good shot.
Wade for three. Won't go. Pierce the rebound. And the Celtics will call timeout. Wade grabs his left leg as he falls down after the shot attempt. He's in some discomfort right now. We saw him have that leg massaged a little bit earlier on the sideline.
Good open look. Looked like he may have landed a bit on Ray Allen's foot. And Wade hurting right now. They'll check the him. Celtics ball with 11.7 remaining when we come back.
And if you go with us, it'll be a win-win.
Certainly will.
I think this could be a win-win.
Maybe.
This is going to be a win-win.
Win-win.
A what? A win-win!
You should say win-win. Use a hyphen.
You know what this is?
Win-win.
A home run.
That's my next guess.
Win-win.
Drink.
Man, this trip was great. I mean, I just, pumped.
We know why you fly. We're American Airlines.
Dwayne Wade still down as he hurt himself. He landed on the foot of Ray Allen when he came down after missing the three that would have given the Heat the lead. He has been just superb tonight. 34 points, 8 assists. Right now, getting some aid from his teammates and from the training staff. Watch as the left foot lands on the right foot of Allen. Again, that's the leg that he was having massaged earlier. Looked like he had cramped up a bit. And he stayed down for a while. Obviously, he's going to come out now. There's a good possibility of an overtime. So you hope for Miami that it's just a cramp. Having it worked on right now. Meanwhile, it's the Celtics ball, and Miami has a foul to give. How do you use that, Jeff? What's the best way?
Well, you want to use it on the way to basket. And if Boston's smart, they'll go a little bit earlier. Now, what they've done, Boston has, is they're playing small. They're bringing in Michael Finley and playing Garnett at the five. So you have more shots. And this is a time, Mike, Mark, I think you make the guy who's coming in cold and who hasn't played in the second half make and take the shot in Michael Finley.
Meanwhile, Flint Richardson comes in for the Heat.
And Doc Rivers tells his guy, He wants them to attack the paint area with 8 seconds to go, so he wants them to go early, understanding that Miami has a foul to give.
Shot clock is turned off. Celtics will try to go for the win. Again, the Heat with a foul to give. Pierce, final sentence. Pierce puts it up for the win. Knocks it down. Celtics win. Dwayne Wade finishes on the bench as Paul Pierce with a superb game. Able to hit, now officials will review it, but it looked like he clearly let it go before the buzzer, and the Celtics will take a 3-0 lead in this best of seven series.
Big play by Paul Pierce. Here's my question. You got a foul to give. Why leave it in the bank? Perfect situation. It does not get any better. He sets it up. Clock dwindling down, the ability to take the hit when he goes into attack mode. You allow Paul Pierce to almost make that last play as if he's standing on the court all by himself. Big time play by a big time player.
11 points in the fourth quarter for Pierce, 32 for the game, including the game winner. And the Boston Celtics get the road win. A heartbreaking, crushing loss for the Miami Heat. They were demoralized after the game 2 29-point blowout. And this one is just devastating. Pierce, the game winner. He's with Lisa.
Thank you, Mike. Paul, just describe that last play. Take me through it.
Well, that's a shot I hit a number of times, you know, playoffs, regular season. I told coach, just give me the ball at the top, give me the right side, and I got to my sweet spot. You know, I wanted to make sure there was no time clock, and I drained it.
Now, you knew they had a foul to give. What were you thinking was going to happen?
You know, if he had to came up and try to get the fouls, we'll try to get it up quick, but I really didn't think about it. I was just winding down the clock. You know, everything's moving so fast when the clock is winding down, so. You know, I just wanted to get to my spot, get my shot up.
You had 11 points in that fourth quarter. What was working for you in that fourth quarter?
You know, I was going to the mid-range jumper. I found I was open when I was getting to the hole. They were collapsing on me. So I found, you know, some little gaps in the defense. You know, they're a great defensive team. So I was just taking advantage of it.
All right. Thank you very much, Paul. Congratulations.
Lisa, great victory for the Celtics and a terrific performance for Paul Pierce. Up next on ESPN, more NBA action. Dallas takes on San Antonio. This has been a presentation of ESPN. The Mark Jackson, Jeff Van Gundy, Lisa Salters, and our entire crew. This is Mike Green saying so long from Miami. Now let's go to Dan Schulman in San Antonio.
Mike, thank you very much. A 10-0 run for the San Antonio Spurs after Dallas made the first couple of baskets of the night. Tim Duncan already with six. He's had 52 points, Hubie, in the first two games of this series. For a guy who's supposedly maybe a little past his prime, for a team that's supposedly maybe a little past their prime, they're doing a pretty good imitation of a championship caliber team. They were great in game two.
Well, their defense tonight is excellent. They're trapping the side pick and rolls. They're holding Dallas the one shot attempt. They're getting out in the open floor and making things happen in transition.
Richard Jefferson, so important.